Please tell your lovers and friends that Ursa Johnny.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Hi there.
Hi.
What kind of sleeping pills do you take again, dude?
Oh,
well, over-the-counter ones or?
Illegal.
Whatever you take.
He does both.
Give me the one, you know, the bottle that has the skull and crossbones on it. That's what I need. What are you taking these days?
Well, I like Simply Sleep.
Simply Sleep?
Yeah. It's like Tylenol PM minus the Tylenol.
I thought you were going to give me an Ambien, the Razapan or something. Or
Razapan.
I don't know.
I don't technically have a prescription for those sorts of things.
Right.
He has a phone number.
So you don't want to admit to taking them.
I'll call my boy Jose and see what he can do for you.
All right.
So that guy across the street in the parking lot doesn't need a prescription.
But what do you recommend?
He said Simply Sleep.
Simply Sleep works pretty good.
What is Simply Sleep?
It's like Tylenol PM minus the Tylenol part.
So you're not getting PM. That groggy feeling either.
It's
when
just
you
the
wake
PM.
Up.
It's just the PM.
Got it.
It's, you know, people try to fall asleep on them until they take seven of them.
Right.
But you don't need all that Tylenol in your system.
Yeah.
Just give me the sleepy part.
So I take one sleepy part and I'm out or what?
I take two. And a glass of wine.
And a glass
of wine. Yeah, I hope you're not busy for a week.
And a fifth of vodka.
Yeah, no kidding. Baby keeping you up?
What?
Baby keeping you up?
The baby doesn't keep me up, Terry. I love to get up for the baby.
Uh-huh.
Never been blame it on the baby.
Okay.
Got the mother-in-law to blame things up.
How come she didn't get up to get the baby?
Well,
she's up at 3 a.m. and TV's up so loud.
I know.
I actually took something last night. I thought it was a sleeping pill. I don't know what the hell it was.
And?
I don't know. I didn't fall
you
back to sleep.
You don't remember anything? Or
I didn't fall back to sleep. I said, I think this is a sleeping pill.
I took my Cialis by mistake.
And I took it.
You're not sure what it was?
I was pretty sure, but I didn't fall back to sleep.
Do you have a 24-hour erection? Is that...
Did you read the label, the bottle?
There was no label on it, but it looked like a sleeping pill. It was very tiny.
It was just a pill laying out there?
It was, I'm pretty sure it was a sleeping pill.
Now watch them all of a sudden just fall out right in here. Because
no,
I'm
wide awake today. What are you talking?
Just has a delayed reaction.
Right.
You might be able to get a prescription for Ambien if you play your cards right.
I'm going to try to do that.
So how do you play your cards right, Mr.
You just tell the doctor very simply, I have a new baby. He's an infant, and he's keeping me up from time to time, and give me some Ambien before I kill you.
There's got to be a doctor out there that would do it just for not even saying that.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't have to say that.
Yeah, my doctor.
Call in. Call in right now.
Yeah.
No,
unethical doctors. Call now.
Forget the kill you part. Just everything else I said should pretty much do the trick, right?
And one of the doctors says, well, that's part of being a parent. It'll get better over time.
I say, listen, doctor, I'm paying you how much to be here for nothing? You write whatever prescription I ask for.
Right.
Yeah. Everyone's taking Ambien, and no one seems to have reasonable excuses amongst the group of people that are taking it, so give me mine.
Okay.
Ambien's no joke, though. You need about 7 or 8 hours, you know, of sleep.
No, I hear that's not the case. I hear that if you go to sleep, let's say... Oh, this is a great conversation.
I know.
If you go to sleep at, like let's say, 10 o'clock, and then you wake up at 1, and you realize you get your feeling that I'm not going to fall back to sleep, even though you have to wake up at 5, your alarm's going to go off at 5, you can take an Ambien, only sleep the 3-4 hours, and feel fine. That's what I've heard.
It knocked me out, so that's what I mean.
Oh, wow.
I know, it does knock you out.
Yeah.
But when you wake up, you don't have to, like, sleep it off. You don't have to sleep off 8-9 hours of it. If you take it, as long as you go to sleep for a couple hours, you'll wake up fine. That's what I hear. Tell me I'm wrong.
I took one around 9:30 on a Saturday. I think it would, like, give me a little buzz. Woke up at 7:30
well,
on Sunday.
Well, I'm not saying. If there's not an alarm going off, you're going to sleep it off. You're going to sleep forever.
That's what I'm saying.
But I'm hearing... through my drug connections, that if you have an alarm that has to go off and you wake up, you're not going to be groggy like you would a Nitol or
you're totally right. It doesn't make you groggy at all.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's why it's better than your over-the-counter little dillies.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So there.
My only concern
I went up touch out on a drug.
You did.
No, but you're right, though. It doesn't make you groggy. But if you don't set your alarm, you will sleep for 7 or 8 hours.
Well, don't you set your alarm? You don't set an alarm?
No, I do. I'm just saying, like, if you do it on a weekend or if you do it on another time, don't plan on just getting up at the normal time.
You do it recreationally.
Because you will sleep.
No, it's on those nights where I get up, you know, 1 o'clock in the morning, and then I'm just staring at the ceiling, and I want to go back to sleep even though I only have, like, 3-4 hours of sleep time left. Those are the times.
Mm-hmm. It'll work for you.
All right.
Wow.
Tell your doctor to call me, too.
All right.
Ooh, my back.
That's what I tried last night with this mystery pill.
And it did not work.
It didn't work.
You were still staring at the ceiling.
Well, my hemorrhoids are much better, though. Magically. So go figure.
The T-Man.
Attention, keep that in mind.
We work it, we groove it, we have it, they don't. Mm. They got the ring.
Yeah, sure.
We got the grooves. We got the moves.
Yeah, that's just one of the many emails we've gotten of women wanting to go on this Vegas trip, Terry.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Women with the grooves and moves and
yes,
all that?
Claiming they got a lot going on.
Really?
And maybe that's going to be one of the ways we start taking qualifiers, because I'm sensing that the people who get through on the phone lines just don't have the juice.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
But these emailers that I'm reading, I mean, I spent a good, what, couple of, let's be honest, about 9-10 hours yesterday reading emails from women that just seem like they're such the Vegas type.
And the reason...
Seem like they're so gung-ho, but just can't get through on the phone lines,
that's
Terry.
That's what I was going to say. That's why they're emailing you.
They're emailing, they're saying, hey, qualify me.
Right.
They're even suggesting, they're even making note that they heard some of the lame asses on the air yesterday. If you heard yesterday's show, you heard a bunch of lame asses calling in. Saying, I don't even remember what they said. It was so forgettable.
I want to go to Vegas.
Right.
Yeah.
Pretty much that.
What happens there stays there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, although, the dirty dog of the group, you know who I'm talking about when I talk about our immediate family here, Terry? You know when I say the dirty dog of the group? You know when I talk about the slaves of the crew? You know who I'm referring to? Of course you do. It's Kilbreth.
He's the first one that came to mind.
He writes me an email yesterday, as quick as Mount St. Helens blew up, as quick as it started in exploding, whatever the exact the terminology is, as soon as the steam started to rise, I get an email from Kilbreth saying, hey, I got a way to qualify someone tomorrow. Have the first person who can come down who can blow like St. Helen.
Wow. Like, it's a catchy name.
Oh, Stephen. Wow. Come on.
I appreciate, Stephen, that you are looking out for the show's interests and trying to maximize the... Yes, trying to maximize the quality that the show can bring forth. But it was a little bit interesting to see that you want someone to come down who can blow like St. Helen and wanted me to play it off like it was my own idea. I can't do that.
All the credit is going to go to you, Stephen.
And now he'll be like, no, I meant to blow into a clarinet.
A musical instrument.
A blow into a balloon.
There you go.
Well, but, I mean, your imagination can run wild.
Wow. But since Stephen did take the time to come up with this brainstorm of an idea, Terry, why have it gone away?
Oh, we shouldn't.
If there is someone out there who damn well can blow like St. Helens.
Woo!
A plume of smoke and ash and dust, 36,000 feet into the air.
That'd be great to see.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
You ever have a night like that?
Wow.
Once in a while.
Speaking of that, are we going to hear from our portly redheaded friend today? Are we going to have to call him? Or is he going to call us?
I bet he wants you to call him.
Because he wants us to call him?
You kind of get that sense, don't you?
Oh, geez. Yeah.
He likes to be begged and called, yeah.
Well, when we
he's
do...
like, I can't believe T-Man hasn't called me back, and he's been back 3 days.
I'll tell you what. When we do have the moment where we qualify someone today for the Vegas trip, for the party play and the lost wages, Terry, and when we do have that moment when we announce amongst the qualifiers yesterday, when we announce who's won a seat for them and a friend, we now have a new theme song, apparently, as put together by Hotshot Scott. I don't know if it's a good one.
Good job.
But he did put one together. Sometimes these things are a work in progress.
Right.
You can tell me what your thoughts are, if this is going to be the permanent theme song, or if this is a theme song that needs work, or whatever other comments you may have.
Okay.
And, Stephen, I'm going to be looking for your comments, too. Are you still stuck on that notion of someone coming down blowing like St. Helen?
Well, look at both of us coming up with something for today.
Oh, geez. Yeah, so you're going to wonder what I'm bringing to the table tonight. All right, well, here is the theme song that would... pretty much be every time we start mentioning the Vegas party plane trip, Terry.
Okay.
You got to keep that in mind. Do you want to hear this theme song every time we pretty much start talking about the Vegas dilly?
Okay.
All right.
Gotcha.
Oh, dear.
Wow. Hit me! It's the get on board.
All right, stop it. I'm already sick of it.
Really?
War on you?
Why?
I don't know. Just the hit me and the...
Playing blackjack. Hit me.
I understand the reference.
Hit me! Get on board and go to Vegas with the cube staff thingy.
That seems pretty senseless, but whatever.
If you prefer the buffet over the pool, then please don't call us.
A little less conversation, a little more action, please.
Oh!
All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me.
Right.
A little more bite, a little less bark. A little less fight, a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart. And baby, satisfy me.
Uh-huh.
Satisfy me.
Yes. Not necessarily as direct as Blowing Like St. Helen Terry, but pretty damn close.
This is the theme song they use for the TV show.
TV show of what?
Las Vegas, so it's
great.
They
do?
Works great.
Sounds like it's already been used, though. Sounds to me like it's already taken.
Time to move on, then.
Oh, that's why it's good.
Well, it seems pretty simple.
It's either this or me and the guitar going, Las Vegas.
I want to hear that.
Well, then I must ask the question, do you have the guitar on you?
I do not have the guitar on me.
Come on, when don't you?
That's really a good point. I always have it in my car.
Yeah.
Do you have it in your car?
I do not.
Here are your choices, though. You have three choices.
Three?
Yes.
Okay.
It is the theme song until the end of the month when we go on the Strip to Vegas. You're going to hear it every single time.
Okay.
We hear it for the rest of the day, but he comes up with a new one tomorrow because we won't be able to take it tomorrow. Or that one time was more than enough, Mr. T-Man. Please don't play it again.
Boy, can I have some time to think about those choices?
Mm-hmm. They're so tough, yes. Steven, I hope you're thinking as well.
Oh, wow, I got to think.
That's right.
Wake up.
He was using this time to eat a bagel, so now the next to think is throwing him off.
It's a lot of thinking time.
I feel like I'm in school.
Yes.
Can we just draw straws?
Oh, I just found my thinking cap. Okay.
Oh, wow.
But how about we have a lightning poll of one, since you seem so indecisive?
Okay.
How about I just go to the phones... First caller, whoever it may be.
Only to one?
Yes.
Oh, come on.
One is all I need to hear. Don't ever play it again. Play it the rest of the day. Play it every day until this whole big shindig comes to an end. Those are the three choices.
Okay.
All right?
Gotcha.
One call. And yeah, we're going to have 15 Stevens a dickhead. And
right.
You're on the air.
Hello?
Yeah.
Am I on the air?
Yeah. That's how it works. That's what we do.
Second choice.
Second choice. I don't remember what the second choice was.
Neither does he, by the way.
I think second choice just play it today?
No, that's not an answer. You got to give me a direct answer.
Oh, okay.
You can't say second choice.
B.
Right.
Just like high school.
He's not calling above.
Calling for the Ambien, I think.
Mm-hmm. You're on the air.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, how's it going, too, man?
Not bad, sir.
I'd say get a new freaking song.
New freaking song. So never play it again?
Oh, come on.
Okay, fine.
Oh, come on. You know, somebody call in with a little conviction. Would you please? If Kill Breath is going to influence you, Kill Breath is going to persuade you, that's not the one vote I'm looking for.
Right,
come on.
Awfully wishy-washy.
Oh! You're on the air. Could people please turn their radios down? Is that too much to ask? We've only been asking that for how many years now?
Oh,
Scott was here until 10:45 yesterday doing this.
Oh, jeez.
So. Yeah, I mean,
you were here until 10:45 doing that?
It's not going to happen again.
Oh, dude, I didn't know you put in such hard labor. Seriously. Yeah. I thought that was a 5-minuter.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was a 45-minuter.
It was.
Does that make you, like, reconsider what you want to do with it?
No.
Okay.
You're on the air.
A 45-minuter?
Oh, jeez. I guess people can't turn the radios down.
They're trying to get back in the swing of things, I guess.
Uh-huh. Everyone took maternity leave as
I guess so. That's the way it
as
sounds.
As we did. Is that the deal?
No, when they called during break, they could leave them up. That was
mm-hmm. You're on the air. What is?
On the air?
Yes.
Hey, never again.
Oh!
Wow. Now that's with some conviction.
And you're not going to let Kill Breath change your mind, are you?
Never again.
Oh, come on. Never again. I should never play the song again.
No, never again.
Wow.
What did you like about it?
Yeah, did you even... What
song
is
it? You know what? A song that's going to be a theme song, it's got a flow. For some reason, I mean, I like the Elvis song, but you know, it did not flow.
The man felt no flow!
But, like, he's a pro! What
How dare you! You don't have to be a pro to feel flow! The man felt no flow!
Look at Hot Shot.
There was no flow!
Does Flo have a sister?
No. No flow, so it's gotta go.
Oh, jeez. If there's no flow, Terry, it's gotta go. Ask Johnny Cochran. He'll tell you that. However, I think we can compromise on choice B, which was play. That's what the first guy said anyway, now that I think about it.
Right.
Play it the rest of the day. Come up with a new song. Hotshot will have to stay till 10:50 today.
Whoa.
Whoa.
No, that's not what I want to play. Where is it? Where is it? Where's the
Vegas trip thing?
Get me! See, now that I know it's only going to be played the rest of the day, I kind of like it now.
It's the get on board and go to Vegas with the Cube staff thingy.
That seems pretty senseless, but whatever.
If you prefer the buffet over the pool, then please don't call us.
A little less conversation, a little more action, please.
This took you till 10:45?
Yes.
Which part? That beginning part?
Well, the whole thing. You gotta find little cuts. You gotta find little sound effects.
But the cuts and sound effects were over 6 seconds into the song.
You gotta finish your lunch.
The Boy Scout doesn't get here till 10:40, so that.
Oh, the Boy Scout that comes once a month and shaves your back, Steven?
I can show you how to use it.
But it comes on Thursdays.
Less conversation, more action.
Let me see.
I like the song.
You wanna know who today's qualifiers are, Terry?
Please.
Apparently,
yes?
There were, 4 qualifiers from yesterday.
Wow.
Meaning that all 4 people or the shows that follow us, they all played blackjack in their very exciting fashion, and everybody who played won. Is that the deal?
Oh, yes.
Gives you a little false hope as to what to expect in Vegas, doesn't it now?
Yeah. But Eric Powers always lets me win.
Right. Tell that to the dealer at Caesar's Palace.
They're really going
to
care, huh?
Mm-hmm. Because the qualifiers today, one of which will be on this plane with a friend going to Vegas, being a part of the whole party plan experience, are as follows. Brandy Lambertson of Seattle. Have you heard of it, Terry?
I have.
Yes. Brandy Lambertson is a qualifier, as is Chrissy Kenny, as is Kim Vaccio, and Jessica Holston.
Oh, wow.
4 ladies.
4 ladies there.
Is there a pattern developing here, Terry, where this party plan is discriminating against men? Is that a concern of yours?
It is, kind of,
mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are you
yesterday was women, too. We didn't have any guys yesterday
Are you going to quiz your fellow employees here at the station and ask them if they are leaning towards women and women only?
I think that they should really, you know, think about who they're
qualifying. What would Shelley Hart's motivation be to get women and women only, Terry? Why wouldn't she want a big old strapping fella to come on down to Vegas? Strapping. Why wouldn't she want some big dude to follow her down?
I don't know. Maybe she's figuring, hey, the ladies are
How
a
tall
bit...
is Shelley Hart? Is she pushing almost 6 feet tall?
She's pretty tall for you're an average woman. I think she's like 5'10".
Mm-hmm. So she needs one of those big old dudes.
There you go.
She needs a big old linebacker to come on down.
Big old fat Betty man.
Right. So why is she? Why would she
Maybe
be qualifying women and only women, Terry?
The ladies will be a little bit better to party with. Okay. Just, you know, everybody is...
Now, you're expecting... Did I hear right yesterday when you said you expect to be rooming with Shelley Hart during this deal?
Yeah, that's what I was told.
And you're comfortable with that?
Yeah. I get along fine.
Yes, I know you've worked with her for many years.
Oh, yeah.
And I know that you and her have never had a moment where you didn't see eye to eye, but you don't really have that much contact with one another. You're gone by 10.
I know.
And our day starts at 9:30. So over the years, you've really hung out all of about 3 hours.
Right.
Now, how do you know you're going to get along?
Oh, I think we will. We're pretty, I'm pretty easygoing.
Mm-hmm.
Not that difficult of a person to get along
with. Is that right?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Plus, you know, I know that she's a big gambler, and she loves to go to Vegas and stuff like that, so...
And you both can enjoy the senior discounts in Vegas.
Sure.
Now, do you think, with your hint of lesbianism and perhaps hers, Terry, that you and her, in a private moment, in a room, in a Vegas hotel, may catch each other's eye in the right light and decide maybe to go after it or what?
I doubt that.
Oh, jeez. What if the decision is made for you? What if you wake up one morning and there's Shelley
wow.
licking away or something?
Oh, my God.
And she's like, now that's an old school lunch, baby.
I don't think that's going to happen.
And Sarah says, oh, good morning.
Yeah, and you just look down all puzzled and say, oh, good morning, Shelly. These are things you got to think about when you have a roommate, Terry. That's why I room with nobody.
Right, right. Well, I don't have any. I don't think that'll happen.
All right.
Okay.
Don't be surprised.
Well, all right. I think the worst that could happen is she'll come stumbling in after gambling all night.
And you'll be looking at her saying, a little less talk, a little more action.
Yeah, I'll be all dressed up like Elvis.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not the first time Terry has been told, a little less conversation, please.
Right?
We're begging you.
Wow. Well, that's the qualifiers for the day, though. Okay. Four ladies. No men, Terry.
Maybe
they're quicker to the phone.
The ladies are more...
quicker dialing fingers.
Hmm.
Maybe they're just more anxious about this whole trip idea. Maybe guys don't want to go.
Oh, now, you know that is so untrue.
Women want to party with the team.
Because even for us,
well, maybe
guys
want to go, but women just want it more, Terry.
Yeah.
Women just need it bad.
Uh-huh.
They need it bad, baby.
Yeah, they need it bad.
Ah, I hear they need it real bad.
So bad.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
do you need this trip bad?
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait.
Do you need it bad, baby?
Oh, I need it bad.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely, I need it bad.
See, it didn't take you very long to agree with what I'm telling you. Women need it bad. Men want to go. There's a difference.
Men
want to go. Women need it bad, baby.
Oh, okay.
Stephen, can you repeat those?
Well, men would like to go, and women need it bad. Oh, yeah, they do, T-Man.
Wow.
Oh,
Lord. Right, maybe Stephen should stay home. We're not even there yet. He's creeping me out.
Jeez. And he wants to room with Hotshot.
Mm.
Who's going to wake up all crazy?
Yeah, Stephen's really pushing hard for the idea of rooming with Hotshot.
Well, that's what I was told was going to happen.
But you seemed genuinely disappointed when you found out that Hotshot was not confirmed to be rooming with you.
Well, I was disappointed because he's trying to get a single room, and I think when you're set up to room with somebody and you go off and do something like that, I mean, that's kind
of...
But
when you heard he was close to getting a single room, why weren't you getting excited saying, well, that means I get a single room? Instead, you got angry that you weren't rooming with Hotshot.
I get a single room. That means I get two hot patrollers.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, two?
Man.
God.
All of a sudden, I don't want a single room. Two hot patrollers.
Yeah, but they're Mike and Keith.
Yeah, Mike and Keith. Now, that's an old school lunch, baby. All right, well, I just wanted to know if you're concerned that it's...
Yeah, I am a little concerned.
It's four qualifiers, four ladies, Terry.
Yeah.
You want to see an equal number of men?
Yeah,
you want to see
actually,
all men? What do you want to see, all men tomorrow?
I want to see an equal amount of, you know, people going as far as gender-wise. I think that would be nice.
Well, I don't know if you're going to have it split down the middle 50-50, but
right.
I think when it's all said and done, it's going to be a nice, comfortable 75% women, 25% men.
Okay.
You won't be happy with that?
Well... You know, if that's the way it breaks down, that's the way it breaks down.
You know, it's the T-Man's party plane.
Yeah, it is.
I tell you, it is the T-Man's party plane, right?
It is the T-Man's party plane.
All right. What if I can guarantee you right now it'll be at, well, it'll be 75-25. Would you take that? Would you sign for that right now?
I might as well sign. Yes, I would, because that's the best I'm going to get from you.
Mm.
And I better take it now or else it gets smaller as time goes on.
Oh, jeez.
Well,
one out of every third person on the plane is going to be a man. Isn't that enough?
That's a nice little.
Isn't that the way it should be on a party plane?
Well,
that's not enough.
I think that's fine.
What would you like me to agree on right now?
Why don't we say?
No, it's not going to be 50-50.
Okay.
All right.
Don't you think some of these ladies would like men with on the trip?
How about 65-35?
You want me to sign a 65-35 right now?
Yes. Is that not? I mean.
I want further negotiation. You're on the air. Hello.
Hey, T-Man.
Yeah.
Hey, Terry does not know what she wants.
Oh, jeez.
I am trying to get you
over Dustin, and Dustin actually sounded better.
Wow. Well, so,
that's
true.
Because that chick was sitting there going, hey, I think I'll be okay on the plane. I think. I'm not really sure.
Amazing. All these years, I talk about how women don't know what they want, and yet Terry Free, right before our very ears yesterday, picked a man over a woman when she had the option to select who actually got on the plane.
Right. Didn't care yesterday.
Mm.
Was that
she doesn't know what she wants anyway.
Wow.
Don't call, sir, because I won't be picking you either.
She even said she liked the guy better, and then she went with the woman.
So a little more talk, a little less action. What?
Oh, yeah. No.
I don't know. I'm confused now. But that's a great point. You had a chance
Well, I also, actually, that's the second time I didn't choose a guy, because the guy before that was Mr. Talking
See,
about how
point.
Well and down he was.
That's the point. You just want guys to be on this plane, and yet when guys come on to try to advertise themselves, what do they sound? They sound lame. So 100% women, 0% men. You want to sign up for that right now, Terry?
No.
Oh, geez. I got some big strapping guys that want to call in saying that they'll entertain Shelley Hart the whole time. That we're down there if you want to put them on.
Okay.
What exactly is strapping?
Oh, who the hell knows? I heard it once. I like the way it sounded. You're on the air. Hello.
I don't know what it is either.
Hello?
Yes.
Not us.
I was once in a play in college where the part I was playing, the description was of it was a big strapping man.
Really?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I mean, I've heard it 100,000 times, but what does it mean to be strapping?
So from that point on, I like to refer to myself as big and strapping. But I never knew what it was then, and I don't know what it is now. A tall, strapping man was the description.
Well, it must be you. I mean, you fit the part.
Yeah, baby.
Perfect.
So strapping.
Don't you wish there was a picture of me on the internet, people out there, huh? Oh, jeez. Yes, go ahead. Are you a tall, strapping man?
Yes.
You don't sound like it.
This is Dustin from yesterday.
Oh, Dustin. Well, there's...
Hey, yeah. Dustin.
The man that Terry had the option of...
Well, he never really asked that much about me, so nobody really got the chance to get to know
Well,
me.
Terry hated you, so that's all we needed to know.
I know. Apparently Terry hated me. I didn't know why.
All right. Well, maybe when it comes down to it...
Well, what do you guys consider tall and strapping, then?
Terry, deep inside, really selects women in her heart.
Terry, why do I
And that's
know?
Why she's gravitated towards Shelley Hart for this rooming situation in Vegas. All right.
I understand why.
No Dustin's allowed.
No, what? I'm calling in today. I'm gonna go for chance number two.
All right. Well, when we try to qualify someone today, if you get through, then that'll be nice.
All right. You'll be there. You gonna pick me this time if I get through?
There's no shot of that, sir. But it'll still be nice to hear from you again.
And after hearing him today, it's probably a good move yesterday. Not Bob Monday morning.
The T-Man.
Seattle police tell us they were called 111 times last year to this North Aurora motel.
Oh!
Almost twice as many as the year before.
Oh, Hammy, what are you doing?
Some say unregistered guests and renters who don't pay up are the problem.
Oh, geez.
So local motels are joining the city's effort to fight back.
Mm-hmm.
This motel has installed surveillance.
Wait, is that Aurora, a big prostitution little avenue or what?
It is.
Is that the deal? Oh, come on.
There's some nice places up there.
How are they supposed to get business if not from these customers? Come on.
So local motels are joining the city's effort to fight back.
Fight back how?
This
what?
This motel has installed surveillance cameras as part of the city's motel criminal trespass program.
Oh,
smaller actions are paying off, too.
Mm-hmm.
You want to check in here?
Yeah.
You can't just pay in cash.
Oh.
You have to have a credit card.
Deborah Herrera is trying to...
You can't pay cash anymore. What, cash is no good?
Not there.
Last I checked, cash works.
Yeah, but the cash that they're getting from these people is for...
What is it, Monopoly money? I don't think these these people, as you say, Terry, are sitting at home counterfeiting $100 bills. It's money.
I understand that, but I think they, you know, of course, want to be legitimate clients.
What's a legitimate client?
Well...
Somebody with a credit card is legitimate.
Well,
Someone with cash is not legitimate anymore.
Well,
weeding out the riffraff.
Just want somebody who's in town.
So that family from... A family of four from Minnesota can have a nice stay at this fine hotel?
Right, exactly.
Come on.
That's what they're there for.
That's not who would take that room if not for the riffraff, as you call them. But if it's not for the riffraff, this hotel goes out of business. So what are they trying to do to themselves? They should call their hotel Nooners.
Nooners.
And that's it.
You can't just pay in cash.
You have to have a credit card.
Deborah Herrera is trying to keep crime out. Trying.
Okay.
In fact, Deborah says sometimes it's so bad at this bus stop that there's so many prostitutes and drug dealers that line this sidewalk, it blocks access to her hotel, and she says that's bad for business.
I was saying, on the prostitutes, sorry, not the drug dealers. Anyway, yes.
Earl Fisher tells us that sometimes the prostitutes will work the sidewalk right in front of his hotel.
Yeah!
How does he stop that?
Oh, geez.
Well, he's got a low...
Why would you want to?
Yeah, isn't that their...
How do you start that? That's the question.
Right. Earl Fisher tells us that sometimes the prostitutes will work the sidewalk right in front of his hotel.
Right.
How does he stop that?
Oh, no.
Well, he's got a low-tech solution. This camera...
I hope it's very low-tech. Yeah, it's low-tech. Why don't you get down there?
Don't you stop.
tech it out.
Well, he's got a low-tech solution. Mm-hmm. This camera he aims at motorists who slow down.
Oh, geez.
The city attorney's office says all of these efforts are helping. Does it make it any easier for police?
I think we're giving the police some added tools.
Tools that can at least chip away.
Yeah, that's what this hotel needs is more tools to...
Double-headed police are not really what they had in mind, huh?
I'm sure as soon as they clean up that area, Terry, then this hotel that has been overrun by this quote-unquote riffraff, Terry, is just going to be loaded with out-of-town vacationers from Boston and Maine and Florida and Texas. It'll just be families. It'll be a new Northwest Disney World type area.
Could be. Maybe once that area's cleaned up, then the hotels can get themselves, you know, redone, remodeled, and cleaned up, and bam!
If you have some vision that I just can't see, well, then I'm all for it.
Okay.
Trying to get up to a half star in the book.
I say there's got to be a spot for everything, and why not just surrender and call the hotel Nooners? All right.
Now, where exactly is this on tour? Is it the whole...
Gilbert Plandum!
Jeez.
That's how Gary Ridgway did it.
Wow.
Road police for all those years.
Is it like Chubby and Tubby, or is it north of there?
What's that now?
I think it's north.
I'd say like on 85th, like right around in there.
Right around there, yeah. Uh-huh. All right.
Yes.
So on the hotels that say instead of free HBO, free ABC?
Yeah.
It's quite the bonus, Stephen. Don't undermine the concept of free network television.
Yeah, next week we'll have water in the pool.
Not all
their customers are like, no, you won't.
Right.
All right. Well, hey, they're cleaning up the town. That's what they're doing.
That's
very
right.
Nice. Mm-hmm. And speaking of cleaning up the town, after 2+ days of being back on the air, the phone call has come in from this guy.
Whoa. He's a gay phone operator. He's so gay. He's so phone operator. And now, here's Gay. A good morning.
Some new little character descriptions you can add on to his bio, Terry, that we've learned over the past few weeks.
Yeah?
He's an ingrate.
Oh! Wow!
He's more warped than we ever even imagined.
No, I'm not.
This is things that... Believe it or not, we weren't even aware of about Gay Phone Operator. If you were listening to yesterday's show, you heard the entire scenario of what happened. This bet thing has become just a big disaster, Terry.
Nightmare.
I'm sorry I ever suggested it because it's created a lot of animosity. He realizes that it's been a situation that he can't figure out how to get it done. So instead of just taking it... Like a man.
Oh, boy. In one of those hotels.
And realizing it's just not going to come to fruition, he gets angry and blames me. And I'm trying to find new ways, new strategies, new out-of-the-box thinking, that can help him get to his ultimate goal.
Right.
But his ultimate goal is not a better quality of life, Terry. His ultimate goal is not getting down to 225 pounds, which would be a much more comfortable area of living for him to be at. His ultimate goal is $30,000.
Right.
Once again, you don't understand what I even told you.
I read what you wrote on the instant messages. Was that you writing on the other end?
No, it was somebody else.
Okay, then. It spoke for itself.
Did he post the instant message conversation
he said he was going to do?
He didn't because he knows he's embarrassed to do it, Terry.
Oh.
He knows how ridiculous he sounded. And just to give you a quick recap of everything that's happened up till now, first the Earth cooled, then Gay Phone Operator was born, and the world has never been the same.
that's a quick recap.
Yes. Now you're all caught up. Yesterday, I described how...
Yeah, my big round ass has started global warming, okay?
Oh, jeez.
It is warmer around here these days.
He said, at his last birthday, he said he was going to be down at 225 pounds by his next birthday.
Right.
And I said, if you do that, I'll give you $15,000. Mm. That was back in October. Then I saw him in December, 40 pounds heavier. And I said, yeah.
You said, no, the other way.
Right. Yeah, you want to go in the other direction.
Right.
And I said, because it's something that I know is a slam dunk lock of the year, will never happen situation, I'll double the wager. I'll give you $30,000 if you get down to 225.
Exactly. You never thought I would win.
Because you went from 350 to 400 when I offered him $15,000.
Right.
Okay. So, what do you mean? I thought there's a way to win that bet.
There's I'm at the point.
Figure out how to get it done.
I do this on my own.
So what happens is, then comes January, and here he is in the studio in January, and he's kind of crying, and he's kind of feeling helpless and hopeless, and he's kind of suggesting that it'll never happen, and out there listening is his guardian angel. Out there listening, you never know who's listening on a given day, Terry.
True.
Well, on this day, like many days, our very good friend, colleague, whatever you want to call him, the greatest plastic surgeon that we know of in the area, Dr. Tony Mangabat, was listening, and his heart was wrenching as he heard Gay Phone Operator describe the truths of his life as they were seen through his eyes at that moment.
Right.
Helpless, hopeless, all that other stuff was being listened to by Dr. Tony. Dr. Tony not only has helped people lose hundreds of pounds through non-surgical procedures in the past, but he was offering it to Gay, a philosophy that he was going to help him through, and then once Gay did lose the weight, on top of all that he was offering, he was going to give him a free surgical procedure where he tightened up all the loose skin.
Ooh.
So,
wow.
So he was going to do it all for him.
Okay.
Wow, that is
so
that's pretty cool.
Nice. So I was on the other end of that phone call with Dr. Tony when he told me this could happen for Gay. He would help him do it. It would be done with him and other people that he knows of through in the medical field.
Right.
He gave me a whole breakdown on how it can happen. It all seemed feasible. I had somebody, after I got off the phone with Dr. Tony, call Gay and tell him about this. Gay sounded pretty excited. And then, during the time we head off, Gay, after meeting with Dr. Tony and getting excited about the prospect of losing all this weight, writes me an instant message saying, when I lose all this weight, ha-ha, you're going to have to pay me the $30,000.
Right.
And I write, no! If you do this situation that I set up for you, I'm giving you this newfound way of losing weight. I'm putting you right there. I'm not going to then, after you lose it, say, okay, good, here's $30,000 on top of that. No! Screw that! What am I, stupid?
But that was part of the reason why he wanted to help me.
So Gay writes back,
he wanted me to win the bet.
I just lost all my incentive to do this. Thanks a lot. I'm not doing it now. Bye. And I'm thinking to myself, this is the weirdest guy in the frickin' world.
Yeah, I didn't say I wasn't doing it.
Here's the weirdest guy in the world. Here I am, laying on his doorstep, a prospect for a better quality of life. And that's not his motivation. All he wants is money. The thought of having just a complete new life to live at 225 pounds as opposed to 400 pounds was not his incentive. I just lost all my incentive. The $30,000 is not part of this? Well, screw it. I'm not doing it.
I didn't say that.
That's what was implied.
That was not what was implied. I said I was disappointed, and yes, I lost my motivation to do it.
You're a weirdo and an ingrate.
Quitting. I would be stupid to stop and stupid to not take that opportunity.
So how is the program going if you're still doing it?
Well, once they heard that he pulled out on the money, and the reason they were helping me was to win the bet. I haven't heard from them since. The last I heard
right.
was that I'm supposed to
You haven't heard from them since because you haven't called
else.
Them.
Yeah, does your phone not dial out?
You haven't called them.
I've emailed them 3 times. Dr. Tony has been on vacation, and I'm waiting. I went to the doctor. I had to get a physical. I did everything that I was told to do to start this.
You like the physical. Are you sure I don't have prostate? Try again.
They didn't even do that.
While you have that glove on, can you take me out to dinner, too?
Oh, geez.
Oh,
you've got
to
stop. Oh, but, you know, the bet, he just would have heard yesterday that it was off. He wouldn't have known before yesterday, right? So
yeah,
when he comes back from vacation, then...
If you had any, sense whatsoever, Gay, and we always assumed, despite all of your downfalls, we assumed you had sense. We assumed that you had a decent head on your shoulders. Anyone in your position would realize that the number one priority, far and away, is the quality of life that you could have if you were down at 225. And the $30,000, even though that is by no means nothing to sneeze at kind of money, Terry, that's a
right.
significant amount
oh,
of money.
Absolutely.
That is a distant second.
Right.
And what you don't understand, because you've never been in my situation...
But if you read the conversation, if you
whatever.
Read the instant messages that I actually had to read during my maternity leave, Terry...
Damn!
If you
yeah,
read,
sure
if you read the
off.
Conversations, if you read what he wrote, and this is why he didn't post it, he made it seem like he had no interest to do it anymore because the $30,000 was off the table, and that was the end of that.
Mm-hmm. I still went and met with these people after you told me I wouldn't win the money.
Wow, good for you.
Yeah, that's pretty
You want to lose weight. That's great.
No, but that's the point. I still went. I made them know that, yes, the money was pulled out, but I still wanted to get healthy. I told you from the beginning when you told me that you weren't going to let me win the bet, that that was my incentive, that I've never been healthy. I've never been in shape. So I can't look forward to that, to have that as a goal.
Cockamamie.
No, it is not cockamamie.
Well,
I don't know what it feels like to be healthy. How am I supposed to look forward to that?
Well, I know
what a dollar can do for me. I know what $30,000 can do for me.
I've never won $100 million, but I'd be, you know, I could probably tell you what it's like. I'd be happy. I don't know what it feels like to have
a
cockamamie.
But the thing that's
your life could be summed up in one word.
Did he hang up?
Yes.
No.
Oh.
I thought he did.
Cock-a-may-may.
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 Oh, yeah.
A cock-a-matata.
A cock-a-matata.
Yes, Boonda.
Hey, good morning.
Oh, wow.
What would you like, Boonda?
Let me say hi to you and Kay.
Whatever. Go find a man and realize what you really are.
Oh, geez.
Wow.
Whoa, Kay. I was just going to say hi. It would be nice to you.
Yeah, giggle, giggle, giggle. Hang up.
Really?
Well, I got the giggle, giggle.
Here's a man who actually likes you for the way you are now, Gay. He doesn't need you to be down at 225. And what do? You make fun of him, you yell at him, you ridicule him, you call him names.
Oh, yeah, I'm the bad person in the whole situation.
Can I just say something, though, in regards to Dr. Tony? And it doesn't...
An unbelievable stroke of generosity
right.
by Dr. Tony.
And that, the
hearing
thing
Gay's
that is,
heartache and coming up with a medical way through some
right.
people that he knows in the field.
Right.
Terry, when you're in the medical field, you have all
you
these
have
conferences you go to, you have all this networking, all these connections.
Mm-hmm.
He was using his connections to help Gay without a penny of cost out of Gay's
right.
pocket.
And I thanked him, and I did everything.
And then
he
after it was all
do.
Said and done, he promised Gay he would take all that loose
right.
skin, tighten
I
it all up
my own
free
money
of charge.
To go to the doctor. I did everything
but,
I was required
but you,
to do.
Now you said that you haven't heard from him because he's been on vacation, and that as soon as they found out that the money wasn't involved, that they're not going to help you. That doesn't sound like the
no,
Dr. Tony
not
we
at
know
all.
Because he is such a generous person that. I mean, quite honestly, to see you in better health, in good health, is probably more of a motivation than you getting that money.
I went and saw these people over a month ago. I've been waiting and waiting and waiting. I've emailed 3 times. They said they would get back to me. They finally said, talk to Dr. Tony, and he's been on vacation.
Okay, well,
when
then when he comes
back,
then you talk to him.
I didn't say I was quitting. I've been waiting.
You were going to quit.
Like I'm
so
saying
say
I'm not
that.
Doing
say,
it and then I'm giving up. No, I'm not.
Got to be a little more proactive.
If you read...
I can't be more proactive if you're not contacting me.
I want you to post that instant...
Off.
Post that instant message conversation because that is the only impression you left, that you were quitting, it was over. If not for the $30,000, you had no interest in losing weight. Ka-ka, baby!
Oh, Boonda, you still there?
I know you hung up on Boonda.
Boonda,
do you still think you would love Gay Phone Operator like you kind of do, Boonda, if he were to go down to 225 pounds, which doesn't seem like it's going to happen anytime soon, because he doesn't have the right mindset, Terry.
It does take the right mindset. You're
mm-hmm.
right with that, absolutely.
But if it were to happen, very hypothetically, Boonda, even though there'd be so much less to love physically of Gay Phone Operator, would you still enjoy him as much?
You know, Gay, you should try to lose weight.
Oh,
I'm serious. I think you're going to be a better-looking guy if you lose
some
weight.
Oh,
better-looking.
Wow.
I'm serious. I'm trying to be nice to Gay right now.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't need you to be nice to me.
Damn it, Gay, come on.
So well, people
no,
nice
Boonda, no. The answer is no. It'll always be no.
Mm-hmm. And what about these personalized plates that you got on your little vehicle there, Gay? For a guy who was certainly doing everything he could to try to stay anonymous at work, for a guy who makes it seem like he doesn't want anyone to know out there who he is, the fact that Gay Phone Op is now on the front and back of your car certainly would contradict that, wouldn't it?
Everybody at work already knows. My plates are okay. It was really nice of the person that wrote fag on my car yesterday.
Oh, hey.
Well, and you're making it like you can't see that as a possibility when you put Gay Phone Op on your license plate, that
right.
is something that could result
you know,
from
that.
You
know what? I expected
that.
It. I just am still shocked that people actually have the guts to do that.
That's the first thing he told me when he told me he was getting the plates. I was like, great, now you can look forward to getting beat up.
Right.
I mean,
it's,
gonna,
it's very dangerous to be doing
that. I'm waiting for something to happen, but it's not.
Well,
I'm
it happened.
Not get rid of the plates.
Did I spell it right? Sorry.
Hot shot.
A fag is with an F, not a PH.
Unless you're cool, like, you know, PH with a fat, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Price
all right, well,
since you're on the line, Gay, and since we haven't spoken to you for a good 4 weeks, is there anything new going on in your life other than the obvious?
Other than my stepdad dying, and I've been dealing with that going on. No, nothing else is new.
Oh, we're sorry to hear
so
that.
So your stepdad is not Pappy that we've spoken about in the past.
No, it would have been better if it was Pappy.
Okay.
Oh,
jeez.
Do we like stepdad? Did we like
stepdad? We like stepdad? I never heard of stepdad up till now.
He was
what?
He only beat me sometimes.
Oh,
oh.
No, he
there.
Never did. He was more of a father than my real father ever was.
You obviously didn't look at his website.
All right, Dr. Tony is listening right now, hearing the gut-wrenching conversation you're having, and he's just found you a new stepfather. Okay, and next.
Wow.
Stepfather replacement? But I have no motivation for that.
No. Gay. That is troubling to hear about. If that is someone you were close to, I didn't know anything about it.
Yeah, you never mentioned him.
You never mentioned him to us in the past, but if this is someone that you were close with and it was a loss, then we grieve with you. How about other things that may have happened in the past 4 weeks that may be a little bit more on the cheery side?
Not much happens that's cheery in my life.
Is it because you don't look for those things, so you don't even become aware when they're right staring you in the face?
No.
Or the ass, or wherever else they may find themselves?
Whatever. You know...
20. Hear his latest posting?
What kind of posting?
On his website.
Is he posting another gay encounter that I'd really rather not hear about?
No, it's a sad.
What? What's his posting? Go ahead.
The weight I feel on my chest right now is so heavy.
Well, you shouldn't have gotten that hot Carl.
I'm...
Go ahead.
I'm on the verge of tears. I can't take the stress anymore. I can't handle the loneliness. I am not stupid. I'm not going to do anything. I'm just so overwhelmed. I just want to be happy and have the ability to accept myself the way I am. How can I ever do that knowing how much I hate and disgust even myself? So we're in the happy place now, I think.
But I thought yesterday there was a posting about a big party you had this weekend with a bunch of naked guys.
Yeah.
Well, but if you read further, it turned into a big depression.
Okay. Like everything, huh?
Because now they left him and he's lonely. So.
Oh.
What happened? You had a big party with a bunch of guys at your house?
No, I went to a friend's house.
So why do you even bother to go to those things? It only leaves you unhappy when it's all over. Most people would say, oh, I have a great memory now to draw upon when I'm lonely. But you just get down. So what's the point of even doing anything when the end result is always sadness? What's it going to take to get you in the happy place? We've been asking ourselves that for years.
Me too.
It's a never-ending, bang-your-head-against-the-wall kind of experience.
And that doesn't even help.
It's tiring, even from our perspective, Gay.
Then hang up on me.
We've had a month off from it, too. Still tiring.
And now I'm exhausted from this conversation.
We've had time to recharge our batteries in this situation, Gay, and yet you come on for 5 minutes and we're all drained. What does that tell you?
Welcome to my world.
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
Yeah, but you could turn it around and do something about
absolutely.
It.
You could make an effort to focus a little bit more on some kind of positive in your life.
Yep. What positive?
There's got to be something.
What positive?
Well, you got a new car, and you never thought you would be able to do that again, so that's a plus. So
you're working now.
Hoop-dee.
You're getting a paycheck.
Yes.
You have people at work that I would imagine someone there has got to like you, right? Why don't you focus on that positive?
Somebody's got to, yeah.
Well, there you
at
go.
At least one out there.
Well,
thank you.
Well, don't focus on that. I mean, there are people there that like you at work. You've talked about that.
You get the personalized plates, you're all set to go.
You say they ask you for drinks after work all the time, and you never go.
That happened when I first started there.
Well, they,
they don't ask you anymore.
Yeah, because they know you'll say no. And you just had a party with a bunch of big, strapping guys?
And you have a chance to qualify, like every other listener, for a seat on the
whatever.
Plane to Vegas.
But you would let me go. You're not going to let me go, so don't even.
if you qualify like any other listener and you get selected, you'll be on the plane. But if you're expecting some kind of special treatment like you suggested in an email you sent the other day to get on the party plane, you can damn well forget that idea.
Okay, I didn't suggest that. And if you want me to post that goddamn email, I will.
Wow!
Well, then you're calling Stephen Kilbreath a liar?
No, but does he want us to tell the one that I said I was just kidding? I know he'll never let me go.
Well, if you sent an email that said you wanted to go, but then sent a follow-up one saying, just kidding, he'll never let me go, it leaves the impression that you really do want to go.
I would want to go.
Of course you would.
You'd be stupid to not want to go. But I'm not stupid. I'm not going to be left through on the lines. They're going to hear my voice and disqualify me immediately.
You have just as good a chance as anybody else.
You're a good blackjack player, aren't you? You can win with the players.
Yeah. Win with the players.
Yeah, we really want you on the party plane, killing everybody's buzz. Being depressed. Ooh, so sorry. Woe is me.
Whoa.
Gee, thanks for uplifting the plane there, Gay.
Oh, no, if I got on the plane, it would never be able to take off.
Oh, jeez.
See, nobody even went there.
I know.
But now that you mention it.
Gay. You've kind of gotten to the point. Hello?
What?
You've kind of gotten to the area of life now where you're a one-trick pony and we've seen it all too many times.
Oh, yeah, I'm
well,
played out.
Well, the
woe is me
kind of thing, Gay. It's just, it's got to be recognized as by you as a little tough on everyone, don't you think?
Well, you're not freaking uplifting me any, are you?
Well, did I not call you, what, 4 weeks ago telling you that Dr. Tony had a strategy to get you down to 225? Is that, does it get more uplifting than that?
Yeah, and when you told me about it, did you tell me I wouldn't win the bet at that time? No.
See,
but when I come back to you, and I tell you that, hey, this might be a possibility, oh no, it's a loophole through the magic of the show. If I lose the weight, forget it.
See?
But yeah, that's ridiculous.
This is so absurd.
Cockamamie.
Okay, so you can lose it on your own, which you'll never do, and win the money, or lose the weight with a pretty good chance it's going to happen and not get the money. He'd rather you know, do it the other way.
Do you now see it illustrated how...
No, I would rather lose the weight, and I'm still going to take Dr. Tony up on his offer and work and do it on my own.
You know what? Don't do Dr. Tony any favors.
I'm not saying I am, but I could have had the surgery and tried to get that through insurance paid and not have to do a damn thing.
You didn't want the insurance. You didn't want the surgery because you said you were afraid you were going to die on the table and you didn't want to not be hungry anymore. You didn't like the prospect of not being able to want to eat.
Right. I totally remember that conversation. Because that was offered, oh my gosh.
Right. He didn't want to lose his appetite for tube steaks.
Never-ending cycle. I can't deal with it.
Another month off so we can recharge again?
I know, jeez.
we're going to need a month off to recharge again, Gay.
Man.
Jeez.
Say something happy right now.
Happy, happy, happy.
You're on the air with a Gay phone operator. Go ahead.
The happy one.
Hello?
Yeah, I just wanted to say that he should lose the weight for himself and not do it for the money.
Right.
He doesn't see it that way.
And he's getting all of this stuff for free from Dr. Tony, too. I mean, that's pretty...
And I said, I'm still going.
That's worth more than $30,000.
I understand, but you don't understand that if I had motivation and the motivation was taken away... Terry, I don't know what it's like to be healthy. I don't know what it's like to be in shape.
That's a stupid... No one's buying that angle, dude.
Cock-a-mamie.
Cock-a-mamie. You're on the air with Gay Foam Operator. Go ahead.
Oh,
I'm not here for the Lord guy. Yeah. You're out of here.
No, Lord.
With Gay Foam Operator, go ahead. Anyone there?
Hello?
Yes.
Is this the G-Man?
Yes.
It don't sound like the G-Man.
You're out of here with Gay Foam Operator, go ahead.
You didn't sound like a woman.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah. I just wanted to say that if Gay gets on that plane, he should have to win twice because his fat ass needs 2 seats.
Oh, jeez. It's kind of right, but...
No, he's
can
not.
We say something?
Based on the new letter of the laws of the airlines, he actually might be right, but it's not a nice thing to say.
Right.
What are we going to say, Terry?
If you want,
saying,
he could...
uplifting things. That's what we're trying to get to here.
If you want, he could invite Chris.
Oh, there you go. There's your friend that can come.
You're on the air with Gay Foam Operator. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi. I'm calling from Federal Way, and... Gay Foam Operator, there is no way on this world that I would have given up $30,000... to lose some weight. I mean, I'm overweight, and if T-Man would have offered me that money, I would have taken that bet quickly. I would
have. Randy, don't you freaking listen. I didn't give it up. It was taken away, and I chose to take another option.
But you didn't actually make any progress, Gay. She's suggesting that if $30,000 was staring her in the face, she would have lost at least a pound or two and not gained 40.
No, I've been listening to the show, and they didn't take it away from you. You all this whole time have been whiny, saying, I can't do it. I can't do it.
You didn't even really try, is what you're saying, Gay. You didn't put forth much of an effort. No one could say you put forth much of an effort. If you would have lost 10 pounds, 20 pounds, 30 pounds, we would have said, okay, he made an effort.
Yeah, that's cool. That would have been cool.
Exactly. Exactly. I tell you what. You offer me that $30,000, you'll see me lose 20 pounds in 1 week.
What, you'll move out of the gutter?
Ow!
Wow.
Hey, you know what? You got to do what you got to do. But exactly. You know what? I've been on a weight loss regimen, and I've been doing it on my own. And, yes, it is very hard. And you do have to have an incentive there. But they did offer you an incentive.
Good for you. Tell Jenny we said hi.
Jenny's working for
right.
her. Okay.
Remember when you lived downtown and we called and said, let's go to a movie, and you said, I can't walk across the street to the movie theater. I mean, isn't that incentive to be able to walk?
Not like $30,000.
Yeah.
I guess not.
Then I could just buy a people mover.
You're on the air with Gay Phone Operator. Go ahead.
I'll never understand.
Well, make us understand. Yeah, what are we missing?
Hello?
Go ahead, sir.
Me?
Yes, you.
Hey, I just want to know why you're so fat and lazy, man. I mean, come on, give us all a good reason why you can't get up and make that money. What's up with that? I mean, honestly, I mean, there's no reason that no person in this world could not make that $30,000. I don't care how fat you are.
Dude, you don't know what you're talking about. You don't know what my limitations are.
Man, your limitations will get bigger and further away from you as you get up and walk every day.
I can barely make it to work, and you want me to exercise and do that? No, it's not working.
It sounds like a lame-ass excuse to me.
You know what? Well, you're a freaking idiot.
How am I an idiot? I'm not the one that lost $30,000.
Yeah, you are the master of excuses. You are the master of woe is me. And you are the master of ridiculing anyone who has any suggestions, advice, or even good cheer for you. Even when Bonda comes on as a fan of yours. A never-wavering, a non-dying fan of yours. All you do is ridicule and then yell at him. How do you win with Gay Phone Operator?
What's interesting...
Ah, come at me!
Now, Gay, you know that there are many people in the same situation as you who, A, you know, when doing it on their own, they can understand your pain. Yes, it's hard and difficult to get up and walk, but sometimes you got to fight through that pain to get to your goal. And you never want to do that. So we even try and find other alternatives to get you started.
It all starts with one step in the right direction, Gay.
Which I've Before taken you know, that other alternative, I've just been waiting over a month to find out about it.
One foot in front of the other, and soon you'll be walking across the floor.
Hey, yeah. Oh,
yeah, there really is no easy way out.
Oh, geez.
You have to work.
I wanted an easy way out.
Well, what happened to the chiropractor who was helping you with your back?
He offered me a year's worth of services, and I went. And
you
he
got a lot
me.
Of offers, dude. That's
yes?
all I know.
Oh,
that's
gosh.
All I know. Maybe we've been the worst enemy because we throw all these offers okay. that he gets through the show, whether he wants to acknowledge it or not, and because of that, it's made him lazier than he would have ordinarily been if he never
that's
would have
so
met us.
Cool.
If
that's
he never
so
would
cool.
have met us, maybe he'd have been a lot better off.
Could have been.
Maybe we're his worst enemy after all.
Yeah, I can just eat whatever I want because they'll fix it for me. What are you scared of in being 225?
I don't know.
It's a long dramatic pause there, Gay.
But you are scared of that.
Yeah.
Why do you have to, like, get all dramatic and whisper sometimes? What is that all about?
I'm sorry, I'm not a specific way for you.
Oh.
Okay? I forget that you want everybody to be like you because you're freaking perfect.
That's right.
We all try
and the
every
sooner
day.
You get
yeah,
there, the better. All right, dude. What else?
What do you want me to say?
Oh, geez. Thought maybe you'd like the final word here.
Does it matter? Does it help? No, it doesn't. You just say something after I hang up.
Well,
that's why you said all this crap yesterday after I was at work and I couldn't call in.
You were in a meeting.
You've called in now. That's why I'm giving you the final word.
Oh, thank you.
You can make a statement, and whatever you say will not be rebutted. It will not be...
Well, so we're going to look forward to you going on this program once Dr. Tony comes on back, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Well, that'll be great.
That will
be
awesome.
I'm not quitting because the money was pulled out. Yes, I was disappointed, but I'm still doing it.
Good.
That's happy news.
Yay!
Okay.
Arriba, chichi. Okay. Aha! Cowbell.
All right, man. See you later, buddy.
No, have a great gay day or anything. Jeez.
Changs?
The T-Man. It's the Cube.
It's Miss American Pie, Shannon Elizabeth, saying bye-bye to her husband, actor Joe Reitman.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. Shannon's reps tell Extra the separation is a mutual decision and they remain friends.
Right.
Shannon put on a brave poker face at the Bellagio in Vegas this past weekend, joining Toby and Leo at the table.
Mm-hmm. She was playing cards there to celebrate her divorce.
Wow.
For her pending divorce.
Mm-hmm.
I'm shocked that Shannon Elizabeth wasn't able to make her marriage work.
It's tough there in Hollywood.
I figured she'd be the one to buck the Hollywood trend. I figured she's brighter than all the rest.
Well, there's still plenty of marriages that are working and stable there in Hollywood.
Is that right?
Sure.
You want to name me two?
Denzel Washington and his wife have been married.
She's not a Hollywood type.
Well, no, she's an actress on...
Really?
Yeah. On stage.
She looks the other way when Denzel gets his other situation's going, I guarantee
so,
you.
Probably. But, hey, it's still over like...
Do you think Denzel's cheating?
No, I want to believe he's not.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I'm telling you, I want to believe.
Okay. That's what you want to believe.
That's what I want
to
believe.
Why? If he is cheating, that means there's chances for you to have sex with the man. So why would you want to think... Do you think the prospect of that is so slim that you'd rather think he's as good a guy as you believe in his,
right.
in your heart that he is?
Yes.
And in order to be a good guy... All in all, you have to be a faithful guy.
Yeah.
Is that your opinion on that?
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You can't be a good guy and be unfaithful.
No, I don't think
There's
so.
There's no way.
No.
Once you're unfaithful, you've lost your chances of being the quote-unquote good guy.
Yes.
You give to charities. You walk old ladies across the street.
Yeah.
You, what else is good?
You cure cancer.
You cure cancer.
But
you cheat on your wife or your significant other, you've lost your chances of being a good guy in your mind.
I think that you know, diminishes all the good things that you've done.
So if you do cheat on your wife, then you might as well be a total bastard. Not give to charity. Push the old lady
into
the gutter.
That's the way.
Because you can't be a good guy anymore in your mind.
Why even try, right? So you can't even get it back? You can't, like, earn some good guy points?
No, I just... Because
wow.
I think
well,
cheating
you
is a huge deal to me.
But if you become a reformed cheater, if you, like, change your ways, you're saying once a man has cheated, he can't go back, or you can reform yourself?
Well, you can reform, yeah.
But if you're actively cheating, no matter what else you're doing...
Right.
You're not a good guy.
Right.
Don't you think that's a little narrow-minded, Terry?
No.
No?
So if somebody cheated on a girlfriend in high school, bad guy, rest
no,
of their
like
life.
For example.
No, Terry, what's the window of how long you've gone without cheating that, okay, now you have a chance of being a good guy again? How long do you have to go without cheating? Terry is so scored. She's
bad. Here's a fine example. Here's a fine example of somebody who I really, in Hollywood, who I thought was like the end all, and it's Bill Cosby.
Mm-hmm.
And I find out he's a little tarnished now for me because he admitted that in the past, yes, he has screwed around on his wife, and I'm like thinking, come on.
All right.
I mean, and my children even watch, you know, all the reruns of the Cosbys, and they think he's Mr. Wonderful, and I'm thinking to myself,
he's not a good guy.
He's not a good guy, and that bums me out.
And you don't want to find out that Denzel's wife is looking the other way because that's the way...
I would not only be disappointed in him, I'm also disappointed in her for looking the other way.
Oh, geez.
Unacceptable.
Then she'd be a bad... She'd be not a good girl.
Right. Well, I think that's, you know, diminishing
herself. She'd be an unfortunate
herself.
Girl. I see. Well, that's very, very interesting that it's a one and singular, one and only criteria to be a good guy or a non-good guy. If you cheat, no chance of being a good guy.
Did you ever answer the question about how long it takes?
No, I did not.
She's
What's the statute of limitations, I'm wondering?
Yes, we're all wondering when we could be good guys again.
I don't know. For you guys?
How long? Is it 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, 1 year? What's the...
It's definitely not 1 year.
You have to go longer than 1 year.
Yeah.
You have to prove yourself more than a year of non-cheating.
I'd say like 20, 25.
Come on. Wow. 20, 25 years?
You're the jilted...
Maybe so. And if that's the case, then hey.
I wonder how many women would agree with you.
Probably
I wonder how many you think. I don't know, Terry. I don't know if everyone's so tunnel visioned on good guyism.
But I think that infidelity is pretty a big, you know, mark against somebody.
Well,
both genders,
you obviously
by the way.
Do if you're saying you can't be a good guy if
both
you're a
genders.
Cheater.
But yeah, people get married real quickly after they were out of a relationship where they were cheating, so women don't care.
If you kill someone, you can be a good guy in 3 years.
Right, but if you're unfaithful, right. 20, 25 years, then you can be a good guy again.
Right.
Got 24 years to go.
Yeah, that's good.
23, 22, I don't know, I lost count. Anyhow, well, I'll be cheating later today, so 25 years and 12 hours.
No, so does each offense count? Is it 50 years if there's two offenses?
Mm.
Stephen, you sound like cheating is okay with you.
I don't think cheating is okay at all.
Your window is all right.
But Stephen is at least flexible enough to think that a guy can have maybe an indiscretion type event.
And is still a good guy?
But when you look over his total scope of his way of going about life... You look over other areas and you say, okay, he does this, 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 and this. That's all good stuff. I'm going to eliminate the prospect of him being a bad guy compared to all the other good stuff he does.
Right. I mean, it's a complete body of work.
You don't look over the entire body of work.
No,
body of work to look at.
I think that if a person is going to cheat on somebody that they supposedly love and are committed to...
Bad guy!
Yeah, they have no respect for anything else that they've done.
And as much as we're making it seem we have a problem with your line of thinking, I cannot say that what you're saying right now is completely unreasonable.
Right.
I mean, let me ask you.
Even though it hurts me to hear it. Yeah.
Stephen, so if you cheated on Amy.
Oh, geez. Well, it was a half-hearted Amy, yeah.
Yeah. she would still think you're a good guy?
Well, that's different, but the whole world, you're saying, should perceive this person as a bad guy. You're saying the whole world should perceive Bill Cosby as a bad guy.
I bet a lot of people like me were disappointed. We're like, whoa.
Disappointed, fine.
And don't think he's really that good of a guy anymore.
A bad guy is a label, Terry, that is a big deal in my mind.
It's a farce.
I don't want to be a bad guy. I want to be a good guy. And yet I've never found a way.
People think Regis Philbin's still a good guy. He cheated on...
Even Joy thinks he's a good guy.
Yeah.
She took him back.
She did?
I mean, that's something that's between the two people that are involved in it. I mean, the rest of us are insignificant in that.
Jesse Jackson, bad guy?
All the things
he does for the community.
I understand he's
that look up to him, bad guy?
Yes. Because I don't have a lot of respect, even though he's done a
some
ton
of the
stuff.
Best, some of the best, most decorated men in the history of this planet.
I know.
Have cheated on their wives or in their relationships.
And like
Terry,
I said,
all bad guys.
It diminishes the things that they have done.
Man,
because I think it's their way of covering up, you know, or getting to be able to continue doing more dirty work.
Mm-hmm. Abraham Lincoln had the gayest and straightest orgies every Friday night, Terry.
Wow.
Really?
On alternate Fridays.
I didn't know that.
He would bring in a different type of orgy. Bad guy?
Wow. God. I'm highly disappointed. I'm throwing all my pennies away.
Oh, jeez. You're on the air.
Hey, I got a question for Terry.
How did this whole conversation start, by the way?
Shannon Elizabeth.
Denzel.
Oh, this all started on Shannon Elizabeth.
Hollywood marriages, and I said that Denzel and his wife been together for a long time.
You don't want to think he's a bad guy.
Right.
Yes, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I got a question for Terry. Terry, do you think Martin Luther King was a bad guy?
Did he cheat on his wife, Martin Luther King? Is there talk about that?
I haven't heard that.
Yeah, didn't know that, huh?
Are you going to call Martin Luther King a bad guy, Terry?
Oh, my gosh. See, again, I'm disappointed.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, and you see, and the thing about that is...
That's sad.
He was threatened. He was threatened. J. Edgar Hoover had pictures of him. You know, with the other woman. And he said, if you don't stop doing what you're doing, I'm going to show these pictures to Coretta.
And he said, go ahead, because he wasn't going to stop doing what he's doing, because he had the fortitude to know that what he was doing was right, even though he had committed an indiscretion.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the next Martin Luther King Day, or perhaps maybe later today, when you have a thought about Martin Luther King, know in your mind, Jerry Free sees him, based on her criteria, as a bad guy.
God, I'm disappointed again.
Do you think maybe you want to take back that overall general blanket statement, Terry, of any man who cheats is a bad guy?
Again, let me reiterate something here for you. I can tell you that even though this person has done a ton of great things, that doesn't mean that he's a great guy.
That's right.
We're just asking for good.
So, there you go.
What else do you have in your pile, Terry?
News about...
You're a pile of crap.
News about Ellen DeGeneres.
All right, bad guy.
Bad guy. I like Ellen.
Okay. Good guy?
Good guy.
Okay.
As far as I know, I don't think she's cheated on anybody.
I bet she has.
I bet she has, Terry.
Oh,
yeah.
Well,
oh, yeah.
I thought she was smart enough to break up first and then...
All right.
Anyway.
Secret lesbian sex. So all you need is that semantic. All you need is that we broke up a week earlier before I screwed 16 people, so technically I didn't cheat. That's all you need is a loophole?
Is that a loophole? Do you consider
that's
that
a loophole?
That's a loophole
in a lot of cases, Terry. Oh, we were on a break. Give me a break.
Yeah, too bad the other person didn't know about
right.
the break.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Anyway, Ellen DeGeneres wants everybody to know that she is finally healthy again, and so is her cervix. Apparently,
she put out a press release saying that there?
Pretty much. Talked about it on her show.
What happened to her cervix?
Apparently, she went into
besides
her doctor for just a little checkup or whatever, and
all
then
right.
they found polyps on her cervix.
Polyps on her cervix?
Yes.
What is that, like warts on the puss?
Yeah, well.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Anyway.
Maybe that was preventing her from liking guys, the fact that she had warts on the puss the whole time. Is that a possibility or no?
I doubt that.
Or maybe that's the Lord's way of saying, you should like men, or I'm going to put warts on your puss.
Wow.
Probably not, though.
Jeez. Anyway.
Because you're a bad guy!
Anyway, she got them removed. And
all right. Well, that's a happy ending, then, because
yes,
that's curable, then, huh?
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Where is the cervix? It's right inside the old puss there, right?
Yes.
Is that considered part?
I mean, you should know because your wife just had a child.
Yeah, I didn't look.
And they had to thin out the cervix and...
Well, she had a C-section, Terry.
Still? Did she not try and
she
do it
She tried,
naturally?
But she only dilated to like 7 or 8 centimeters.
Whoa.
I never saw the cervix. It never came out to play.
It's not like you... Okay.
Now, I'm asking a question. I'm not as well versed on the female anatomy as maybe I should. I'm just a bad guy. Now, where do you find...
Are you going to be doing that to me all day long because...
I think I've asked this question and had it answered at least twice in my life already, and yet it doesn't register. Where is
up inside
the
your...
cervix? The VJ.
The VJ, yes. A little round thing.
It's round?
Well, it's not... I wouldn't say it's, like, round, but it's... I don't know
round
how to describe
it.
Because, like,
I wouldn't
for
say
some,
it's round. It's rectangular.
Well, some women have... It's, like, it's shaped
it
with your
shaped?
Body. Well, I guess you could say it's kind of...
Okay.
That way, because some women have
sounds
like
you're not the expert
reverse
either.
Reverse cervix of how it's set up in your body and your hips
uh-huh.
down below there.
Okay, so she had polyps.
But it's up inside.
And polyps are like a warty-like substance.
Yes.
Warts on the inside are called polyps.
Doesn't sound good.
I don't think I want it.
Think I'll take a pass.
But she had them removed.
She did, and she's fine now.
Did they say how many polyps they removed?
Three.
Three polyps.
Mm-hmm.
Is that why she hasn't been dancing on the show?
Oh, geez.
Oh, really? Yeah, could be. Could be.
Well, she should have made that clear to the audience. It's not like I've lost my fascination for dancing on this program. I had three polyps removed. Maybe she did. Maybe she. You're saying
well,
she made
did.
That.
Well, she did. She talked about it on her show, and she said she went to the doctor and...
All right, what would you... if you had gun on your head, Terry, polyps on the puss or yeast infection?
I'll take the yeast infection.
Yeah, that has to be surgically removed, right? The
polyps, yes.
All right. I like playing that game, though.
Okay.
All right, well, that's...
I have a picture of a cervix if you want me to.
Please send it immediately. What else? Yes, please.
Speaking of women and their insides...
are we really?
Let me tell
you.
The cervix.
You are the master of the segue. There's no doubt about it.
I want to talk to you about Britney Spears and how she is no longer interested in having a child or procreating.
Okay.
Apparently, she's had quite enough experience with children because of Kevin Federline's babies.
It's
That's all she needed to see.
Yeah, that's all she needed to experience. And now she's like, yeah, that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of work.
It's the way I felt when I got a dog.
Okay. Want some more news?
Hello?
Is this Jessica Holston?
Yes, it is.
This is T-Man. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Water?
What's up, baby?
Jasmine.
You're on the air.
Okay. I'm at work, so I'm leaving the room.
Uh-huh. What do you do?
I'm a billing specialist. I sit at a computer all day.
All right. Yesterday, you qualified on the Eric Flowers show.
Yes.
To be on the plane to Vegas with the rest of the staff and fellow listeners?
Yes.
Would you be surprised and or excited to learn that you have been selected as the winner amongst the group of qualifiers?
Oh, my gosh. Are you serious?
I didn't even tell her whether she won it or not.
I know that. All you did was talk about how she qualified.
I asked her if she'd be surprised to learn. I didn't say it's happened.
Oh, my God. That's wonderful.
Oh, my God.
You guys know what you're
Well, have a great day.
You're right.
Yeah.
Who would you bring, Jessica, if you were to win? Because everyone gets to bring a guest.
I'm bringing a coworker slash friend with me.
Really? One you share
with
your...
me playing the blackjack, so she gets to go with me.
One you share your intimate secrets with? One you go out clubbing with? One you bring random guys home with and then tell each other that you'll never tell anyone else? All that good stuff, or what?
There's no intimate secrets, but yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Oh, here's the picture of the cervix.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm.
Mm. Okay.
Still doesn't ring a bell, huh?
Still don't recall seeing that, do you?
No, not familiar with her. Anyhow. Jessica, you are the winner.
Am I really?
Yes, you are.
Oh, my gosh.
You're going to Vegas, Jessica.
I'm so excited. Oh, my God.
Congratulations.
I'm going to have to scream and scare everybody.
Now, maybe I should have asked this question earlier, but what do you look like, honey?
See that picture of the cervix?
It does.
I just want to know, when we see you on the plane, when we see you on Vegas, how do I identify you so I can go up to you and say, hey, Jess!
Congrats.
I'm average. I don't know, 5'8", short hair, not short, shoulder length. And
oh, Lord. Yes?
I don't know. What else do you want to know? Are you going to ask me my bra size?
What do you weigh?
Oh, no, we'll go with the weight.
We're close.
No, without, yeah, with clothes, whatever. Right.
Yeah.
With clothes.
Go ahead.
What do you look like?
I asked you first.
Okay, well, I answered a little bit.
What do you weigh?
What do I weigh?
Just answer the question
okay,
so I can
really
know you
personal.
When I see you.
Oh, my God.
Don't ask a woman that.
Oh, that's a bad sign.
Yeah.
She starts off by saying average.
We are off to a horrible start.
With
but congratulations, Jessica.
Yeah, I can't wait to see you.
All right.
Jeez.
We are just not getting it done with filling this plane, Terry. But congratulations, Jessica. You're
Thank
a winner
you so
on Cube 93.
Thank you.
We are just making this dreadful already, Terry. But congratulations, Jess. We can't wait to meet you.
And the co-worker you're bringing?
It's going to be worse than her, I guarantee
you.
Oh,
boy.
This Thank is, you
this
so
is
much.
A cute one.
Yeah, whatever, baby.
Yes.
All right, hang on. We'll give you the info. Ladies and gentlemen, we've renamed this promotion we're doing called Nightmare Plane to Vegas. Would you like to be a part of the nightmare? Join Jessica Holston and her friends.
Do you think she's liking the buffet better than the swimming pool?
Oh, Terry.
That's a question.
Uh-huh.
We'll find out.
Yeah.
That was the hope, that it would be more the listener that would like to hang out in the bikini at the pool as opposed to... In, I don't know.
See
whatever.
How many shrimps you can eat in one sitting?
That's just more people cutting in front of line of me at the buffet.
But we're playing it fair, and these are all listeners, Terry.
They are.
We can't do anything about it. We've tried to shoo them off to other radio stations. It's not working. What if Jessica turns out to be just an absolute stunner?
Oh, there you go.
What if we can just build up hope back up, right? What if she turns out to be just way hot, Terry? What if we all get on the plane, our jaws drop, and the pilot crashes because he's so distracted, Terry, because she's so damn hot? What if that happens?
It's always nice possible.
Man.
Keep the dream alive.
Keep the dream alive.
Something tells me she'll look a little bit like that picture of the cervix you have in your hand.
Mm-hmm. I'll take that right now. If I could sign for that right now, yeah. I would. I'm afraid it's going to be worse.
Yeah, it could be.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to qualify you for the party play for the nightmare plane to Vegas. Sometime in the next half hour, I'll be going to the phone lines to find our next qualifier for the plane to Vegas. Yes.
The T-Man.
Go right ahead. Can I help you?
Yeah, I'd like to go in, please.
I'm sorry, it's a...
I'm average. I don't know, 5'8", short hair, not short, shoulder length.
Oh,
and
Lord.
I don't know what else you want to know. Are you going to ask me my bra size?
What do you weigh?
Oh, no, we'll go with the weight.
Check, who qualified that girl?
I don't know. Maybe Power?
It was the Eric Flower Show, yes.
Was it? Okay.
And maybe I just had the wrong, unfortunately, I had the wrong vision of how this party plan would work. I pictured just a chartered full of hundreds of hot-ass hookers sitting there on the plane headed down to Vegas with us, I guess.
Okay. Hot-ass hookers!
That wasn't completely accurate, and these are fun-loving people that we're going to have a good time with down in Vegas,
yes,
and that's how it's going to be.
That's right.
Fun-loving.
Yeah.
So they're not giving us much to work with, right? I mean, Powers is qualifying people like, this is the best he can do?
I guess so. They're just playing blackjack, and that's how it works.
Up at eight, without, up at eight together.
Let me see what else she said here. Hang on a second. No, without, yeah, with clothes, whatever. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you ask her how much she weighs, and she says, with clothes or without?
Yeah,
I take my 80-pound parka off. Oh, that's awesome.
What do you look like?
Yeah, when you have to start comparing yourself to me, then we know it's pretty much over. Then we know it's a pretty big nightmare. And that's not what the dream was, Terry. We're trying to keep the dream alive.
Uh-huh.
But I asked you first.
Okay, well, I answered a little bit.
What do you weigh?
What do I weigh?
Just answer the question
okay,
so I can
really
know you
personal.
When I see you.
Oh, my gosh.
Don't ask a woman that.
You don't ask a woman that. No, you don't ask a fat woman that. Skinny women or in-shape women are more than ready to answer that question.
Right. They don't care. Right, 110.
Mm-hmm.
No, but congratulations to our latest winner for the trip to Vegas that we're all now dreading.
No. Well, she'll be on the Kilbreath tour bus at 8 o'clock the next morning out to Hoover Dam.
So there you go.
Grand Canyon.
Stephen Kilbreath has set up, he has set up a side tour for those who want to go with him to Hoover Dam.
All right.
Uh-huh.
I'll jump off it if I have to go on that thing.
What is that, the big old dam there? What do you see? What would you be willing
to... It's a pretty big dam. I mean, it's pretty cool.
You going to sit there and stick your fingers in the dike or what?
Oh, you know, one side, there's a lot of water, and the other side is pretty low.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Now, will you be answering dam questions?
I'll be doing any damn thing they want me to do. So.
Sounds like a good 5 hours away from the casino. Worth your while to me.
It's a quick drive.
I'm certainly willing to sacrifice casino time for that, Terry.
Sure.
Count me in, Steven.
Have you been to the Grand Canyon?
I'm going to pack a bag lunch. I'm ready to go.
It's beautiful out
there. Yes. I can't wait. Wow. All these high hopes, Terry, are being dashed. But that's all right.
Then we can go to the Coke factory where they have it squirting out of the thing and you can catch it in the cups. That's pretty cool, too.
Really?
What are we talking about now?
The Coca-Cola thing.
Mm-hmm.
Where's that?
There are things outside of the casino in Las Vegas. It's pretty cool.
Oh, really?
Are you sure?
No, it'll be fun.
If you say so. You're on the air. Hello. Let me go to the phone and see what's going on out there.
Got ya.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
How's it going?
Good.
Oh, I'm so glad I got through.
Mm-hmm.
How's everybody doing this morning over there?
We already said fine. What can we do for you?
Well, I wanted to try and get a trip to Vegas.
All right, well.
I'm going to try and qualify.
This is not exactly the moment where we're qualifying people. We're going to be doing that in the next few minutes, though.
Well,
we were supposed to.
I've lost all my spirit.
Yeah. I listen every morning, and I try to get through, and I got through now, so, you know.
So she'd like to qualify now, if that's all right, T-Man.
All right, pigtails under your arms. I already know. Thanks a lot for the call. I can tell you this, though, Terry.
What's that?
I'm getting a lot of emails from ladies sending pictures.
But that's not how you qualify or anything.
Technically, no, but I'm changing that.
Oh, my gosh, I'm sure.
The rules were made to be altered, Terry. And part of the new rules of this party plane to Vegas is you can qualify through email.
Really?
Send emails to theTMANshow.com and tell us why you need to be on this party plane to Vegas. I should have brought in a bunch of those emails. I'll bring them in tomorrow.
Okay. All right.
I have them under my mattress right now.
Great.
And if you want to explain in full detail how you could be an asset to this trip to Vegas, Terry, mm-hmm. that we're all looking forward to.
Yes.
Terry Frey is going to tear it out.
Oh, yeah.
Woo-hoo! Can't wait.
Mm-hmm.
Me and the slot machines.
Oh, jeez. You can do that right now by going to thetmanshow.com, sending emails and telling us why you need to qualify. I'm going to start qualifying people by email, Terry, because if you heard yesterday morning and you're hearing, I'm sure, what's going to transpire later this morning, people on the phone line sound comatose.
Wow.
And heavy.
Which is worse.
I know, huh?
Let's usually go hand in hand, though. You can ask me that.
Not that this plane, even though it might have been my visual, it was a stupid visual, I acknowledge that. Not that this plane needs to be filled with a whole slew of beautiful people. Heaven knows I'm not pulling my own weight there.
Right.
We all know that. So, we want to go with fun individuals.
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
We can tell how fun they are by their pictures.
Mm-hmm. Nothing illustrates fun more than any pictures you could send.
There you go.
Now, do the other people during the day have the questionnaire that you ask all of the people to know?
Yeah.
I don't know what they're doing.
Maybe you should call it me.
I thought I could count on Flowers and Harris since he's always hanging out with hookers and then strippers.
Right.
I figured I'd go with who they chose and I'd have a good shot.
Well,
that certainly was a terrible mistake.
Yeah, proven wrong.
Although, as I said, we know nothing about the woman that just won.
Right.
She could turn out to be the most hottest supermodel in the world.
Right.
I think I'm ready to make my first wager of the trip. Who wants in?
Yes. I tell you what else is going on, please. What do you have?
I have an odd story out of Oregon. A high school football coach in Halsley, Oregon,
right.
has admitted to licking one of his players' bloody knees.
Licking the cut of a player.
Yeah.
Licking the cut of a high school boy's knee.
Yes. Apparently, he was giving a big speech to his players, trying to fire them up.
So this is frowned upon. You can't lick the cuts on the knees of your players if you're a high school coach.
Yeah, not only that, but I mean, you know.
Yes.
Like, diseases and stuff like that are
spread
that way. Of
course.
He had rubber gloves on, right?
He had rubber gloves on his hands, Terry. Doesn't that count for anything?
Anyway, yeah, he was giving the team a pep talk about another coach.
Terry, nothing says love, spirit, and the true sportsmanship you're looking for in a high school coach than being willing to French kiss a cut.
God, that's just nasty, though.
You going to tell me I'm wrong?
You're wrong.
Oh. Playing 7 minutes in heaven with one of your
players,
soccer players' cuts. Is it soccer, Terry?
No, football.
Football. One of your foot. Mm-hmm. It's our. Well, we're in the springtime now, almost, Terry. Well, who's playing football? Or this was something that happened months ago that they're now reporting
on. He's under investigation, and it doesn't give me exactly when it happened.
Right. Surveillance video of the parking lot.
What happened?
Has uncovered after all these months that the coach was licking his players' cuts.
The players are all coming forward now.
Yeah, a parent complained.
A parent complained.
Mm-hmm. And he admitted, yes, I did lick that boy's bloody cut.
When the same parent will go running to the principal if her son is not getting special attention in class. You can't have it every way, can you, Terry?
No, I guess not.
So, if you want your kid to be paid attention to by the high school staff and administration, well, you gotta sacrifice some things like, licking cuts.
Okay.
What does that do for it, though? I mean, does it stop or something?
I think he was making a point. He was just...
Yeah, he was. I was like I was telling you, he was giving his players a pep talk and was relating about another story about a coach who, what is it, licking and healing the wounds of his injured players. That was his pep talk.
The guy was a creep pedophile. There's no two ways about
it. Well, okay, but I'm just telling you, you know, that he's
got a whole laundry list of things I guarantee you he's done in the past, too. You don't start with licking cuts.
I agree.
That's the tip of the iceberg.
That's like graduation time.
Anyway, and so to emphasize that, he asked one of the players if he could lick his wounds.
All right, well, he could pretty much kiss his career goodbye. Anyway, what else? What else? When you start licking players' cuts, it's pretty much over for you. What else?
I got a story here about a camp intern in San Diego, 22-year-old female, who was fired because she was sharing her lesbian experiences with sixth grade girls at an outdoor education camp.
And that's too young in a lot of people's minds to share your lesbian experiences. What if she was sharing her experiences with her boyfriend? What if it was a, what? How old are sixth graders? They're about, what, 12? 11?
Yeah, 11.
I know from many years of living, Terry, that 11-year-olds, 12-year-olds love to hear any babysitter or counselor, as this case may be. They love to hear the tales. They love to hear the stories. They love to hear the saga of their relationships and their experiences from that older point of view. The only reason this is an issue is because this was a lesbian story. So why did they have munchuation situations? That's why this counselor's in trouble.
I think any story, even a heterosexual story, would be wrong.
No, yeah. It would not. It would absolutely be not.
You don't think she'd be fired? You think
absolutely
she'd be
not.
Totally
every
different?
Every counselor in any camp in this country is telling her 11, 12-year-old campers about her boyfriend.
Oh, yeah. Old Sammy gave it to me good last night. Right. Come on.
Well, that's how you tell your sex story, Terry.
No, but let me tell you this. As a parent of an almost sixth grader.
Is that what you call Mr. Perkins these days?
Oh, jeez.
Now, I wish I could hear the story because it sounds like it's pretty hot, Terry, from this, the Sammy story and this counselor story.
Yeah.
But.
I might start going back to camp.
Yeah, I have to go back to camp and telling lesbian stories now.
Sex stories.
But my point is that if this was a typical counselor telling her 11, 12-year-old campers about her boyfriend and about their romantic getaways, this would not be even remotely an issue. This is an issue because someone overheard two vaginas going after each other.
Wow. I think either is inappropriate.
I'm telling you, it's not. You only, you wouldn't even think two things about it. You wouldn't think anything about it if it was a story involving a man and a woman.
If my daughter, Alexia, came home from sixth grade camp and said, "Hey, Mom."
My counselor was telling me about her boyfriend and how they...
told me all about her and her boyfriend's sexual escapades or having sex and is this how you do it type thing. I would be alerted there and I'd be a little upset.
Well, then it depends how graphic the story was. If it was old Sammy slamming away on her ass, then maybe you would have a problem, yes.
During the weenie roast, you put it right in the bun like this?
That's not the sense I get here. She was just telling her campers about her girlfriend. She was telling her campers about how close they are, how in love they are, how... this goes on, this has gone on for years. Counselors tell their campers about their boyfriends. And no one has thought a thing about it. Now lesbians have come out of the closet a lot more these days than in the past. And someone overheard it, and it's an issue. It's clear-cut discrimination, Terry. Must pound on the table for my lesbian sister.
And say, and tell your stories!
Yes, like any other counselor does when it pertains to her boyfriend. Now, I agree with you. If she was talking about how she was put in bondage by her boyfriend and slammed up against a wall until the neighbors came wondering if anyone was being killed in the apartment, that would be a story that would be a little bit over the head of a sixth grade camper.
Oh, little Susie, you should have heard me scream.
But the counselors typically tell their sixth grade campers because the sixth grade girls want to hear all about it from an older woman's point of view about their relationship with their boyfriend.
I understand that they may ask the question, but I would think that a 22-year-old would probably be smart enough to say, you know what, I'll leave that for your parents to discuss with you.
It's not how it's happening, Terry. It's not how it's happened for years and years and years of camping.
Kids don't want to hear from their parents.
And their parents don't tell them crap. Got to walk in on your parent to see that horrifying experience.
Is that what happened to you?
The parents don't bring up the French tickler. You got to hear that from the counselor.
Let me see that story.
Oh,
how
gosh.
Much exactly? Will you just tell me how much of the graphic details of a lesbian relationship did this counselor actually tell? Because that's very significant
it
here.
Just says
I don't
here,
think it was much.
It just says here that the intern went too far and shared stories about her lesbian encounters with the students.
But if it was a boyfriend-girlfriend encounter, not an issue. What else?
It looks, according to new research published by the British Journal of Developmental Psychology,
that
girls as young as five.
Hold on. I've heard enough stories now. I just realized I want to go back to the phones. Yes, hi.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
I am having a huge problem with my boyfriend.
All right.
And I need your advice.
You should become a camp counselor.
Yeah, you should.
No. But, okay.
Hold on. Let me round up some sixth graders. Hang on. Go ahead.
My boyfriend and I have been together for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
He is still friends with one of his ex-girlfriends.
All right.
He refuses to let me meet this girl. And...
Terry just gave a under-the-breath ooh.
I know.
Like, that is off limits as far as what she's willing to tolerate. Terry's a very tough woman, you must know. In the presence of everyone but her men. Go ahead. So okay. You have your questions about what may be going on. You don't trust your boyfriend.
No, I trust him. I just don't understand why he won't introduce
don't
me.
Don't give me this, I trust him, I don't trust her. Because it takes two to tango. If you don't trust her, that means you don't trust him.
No,
call it what it is.
He's going to Vegas with her in 2 weeks, and I wasn't invited.
What? And you needed to call us on this? Come on.
All of these people from his old high school are going on this trip, and it's going to be great. But the thing is that they're sharing the same room, and he thinks there's nothing inappropriate about this.
Whoa.
And he has you
in this room, and he's sharing it with her, and he thinks there's nothing wrong
with
that.
And he has you debating over this to the point where you have to call us and ask our opinion?
I guess.
Well, he thinks that I'm crazy. He thinks that they're just friends, they're going down to have fun, and I should, you know, completely trust him and not have a problem with it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not the issue about trust.
How long have you been going out with this guy?
2 years.
2 years you've committed to this guy?
Yes.
Are you living together?
No.
You're not. You're having sex how often?
At least once a day.
Once a day, you're handing over the VJ to this man. You are a solid couple, as solid as couples get. If you're having sex 7 days a week on average, and this man has an ex-girlfriend that he has never introduced you to. At first, I was going to say, well, there's a possibility there's nothing going on, and he hasn't introduced you to her only because she's way hotter than you, and he doesn't want to make you angry. But doesn't seem like that's the case. If he already has a trip planned to go to Vegas with her, you have no say in the matter. And on top of it all, he gets the room with her.
Right.
Right.
And you're supposed to just stand by and wait for him to come home.
Right.
When everything goes back to normal
and
again.
And he's right. Convinced you that you're crazy.
No, he hasn't convinced me. That's what I'm, like, everybody that I've talked to says that it's completely inappropriate. Whether anything, you know, sexual goes on.
But
that's
you
not
needed our confirmation.
Right. Even if nothing sexual happens, it's inappropriate.
Right.
You're right.
How often does he talk to this ex-girlfriend? Obviously, what, every day?
No. They meet for drinks every couple months with their little group of high school people. And, like, I'm...
See, you've tolerated. You've tolerated a lot, little by little. A man, I have to... I know a lot of men get angry at me when I give a different point of view than what they would like to hear. But the reality is... You've tolerated little by little things that now that they're established, he will take more. You would think when you are being the tolerant, non-invasive, non-jealous, non-possessive girlfriend, you would think that would lead to him thinking to himself, okay, I got a really cool woman that I'm with now. She gives me my space. She gives me some freedom. And I got to appreciate that. No! All that means is he's going to want more than what he's getting. He's going to want to build on that.
Have you ever met this group of, you know, high school friends of his? Have
no.
You ever?
He goes out to drinks for them, and
they all lick each other's cuts.
I
hear.
I guess
that they're old high school friends, and that I would feel uncomfortable because they talk about old high school things. And I told him, take me along once so I can meet them, so I know who you're talking about. And then
and he said no, and he said fine.
Yeah.
Right, and it's not happening.
And he's...
So I'm getting my boobs done next week.
Oh, geez.
And
let me throw that in, T-Man.
While I'm healing, he's going to be down, you know, sleeping.
She's using that as a threat. She's trying to establish that once she gets her boobs done, she's going to have this new courage in life to actually move on from this guy. That's the threat she's throwing out at him.
No, not at all.
Absolutely
at
is.
All.
Absolutely
but
is.
But she won't follow through, do you think?
No, but she is trying to garner up some courage to actually do what everyone is telling her to do and not put up with this kind of behavior from her boyfriend anymore. So this hope that the boobs are going to be put in there and all of a sudden she's going to get extra attention from all the world and she's going to have the inspiration to move on what she's hoping is going to happen.
Uh-huh.
I'm not like supermodel hot or anything, but I get enough attention without them.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just, I wanted to make sure I wasn't crazy.
And you needed our, again, you needed our confirmation on that.
Kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
every guy should have a girlfriend like you.
You want hot chicks to go to Vegas with you. So if you want me to go, I can bring the girls, and we can go on the plane. And I can send my...
I didn't say we had a shortage of dummies on the plane. I never said that.
I mean, heck, I'm going, huh?
Yes.
I've been to Vegas a couple times, but my new girls won't have been, so...
Are you making up this whole story, trying to get yourself on this plane to Vegas?
I would say call him, but he'd probably get really pissed off or not even answer his phone.
Mm-hmm.
We've been together for 2 years. Our anniversary was on the 15th of February.
When is he going to Vegas with his ex-girlfriend?
He leaves on March 20th, and he gets back on the 24th.
And where are they staying?
At the Luxor.
So your first date was the day after Valentine's Day?
Well, no. He says that our anniversary begins the second time that we slept together. He says the first time doesn't count.
And he expects, and you expect that he's going to be in Vegas for 4 nights with this ex-girlfriend in the same room, and then he comes home and everything goes back to normal.
That's what he's expecting. He knows that I'm pissed off about the trip.
All right, you're pissed off, but you're not going to do anything about it. Mm. So he doesn't care if you're pissed off. If you're not going to do anything about it, what does it matter to him?
You're still having sex every day.
And he'll just bring you back a nice little gift from Vegas and say, oh, see, I thought about you all of, 2 seconds.
He has no true... deep feelings for you, obviously. No real respect for you, obviously, right or wrong.
I would like to think that he does, that he's just being stupid, but that's probably just me.
How far out of high school is he?
He is 6 years.
Well,
I'm 10.
That's a little much, then.
Yeah. You're 4 years older than him?
Yeah.
Do you deserve this kind of relationship? Is this what you expect for yourself, or do you think you deserve maybe a little bit of a guy who treats you a little bit better?
I would like to be respected for what I like, yes.
Huh? You would like to say, I don't feel comfortable with you staying in the same room with a girl you used to have sex with. I'm not going to be anywhere around. And then you come home and just pretend everything's back to normal. I don't feel comfortable with all that. You would expect that to make an impact on him to the point where he's like, okay, I'm not going to do it then. You would hope for that, right?
Well, that's what I told him. I said, it's not anything. I don't think that you're going to sleep with her, but it's just the inappropriateness of it all. She doesn't need to see you in your boxers in the morning, and you don't need to see her,
If he's not going to sleep with her, why is he going to stay in the same room with her? Are you believing that it's more cost-effective and that's the reason?
Oh, no, I know he makes more than enough to pay for his own room.
Then what is your feeling as to why they can't have separate rooms?
Fact
that he doesn't even lie to you and tell you they have separate rooms tells me a lot about how much he thinks of you.
Yeah.
He doesn't even think you're worthy of lying to be lied to. He's not even trying to,
Every time I bring it up, he throws it back in my face that I'm the one that is mistrusting him, and I'm saying you're the one creating the inappropriate situation.
See, he's working his manipulation so well.
This guy has got this woman so in the perfect spot. Every guy wishes he could come home from Vegas with a T-shirt that says, my boyfriend had sex with someone else in Vegas, and all I got was this lousy T-shirt, and she'd stay with him.
Yes, you're right, and it's unfortunate.
I have one of those.
I wouldn't stay with him if anything happened.
What do you mean? You have been the last 2 years.
You honestly think that they're going to... You really believe in your mind they're going to spend 4 nights in Vegas in the same room.
Well,
and nothing's going to happen.
Supposedly she's engaged.
I don't care if she's been married for 50 years.
That's so beside the point.
You honestly believe that they're going to stay in the same room for 4 nights in Vegas and nothing's going to happen.
I know I look like a moron, but yes, I'm hoping that nothing would happen.
And this is radio, and yet, yes, you're right. You look like a moron.
Is her fiancé going then?
No, her fiancé is not going.
Have you ever seen a picture of this woman?
Yes.
Is she hotter than you?
She's as hot.
Huh?
But she's got the exotic thing on me. She's part Mexican, so she's got that, beautiful exotic, and I'm just like straight white bread.
Mm-hmm.
Tasty white chick.
Call her up. If she wants to be on the plane to Vegas, we'll put her on.
Hey!
On the party plane. If she's got that Mexican exotic thing happening, we've got to put her on.
Do you believe that in the 2 years that you guys have been dating that he's never cheated on you?
No, I don't believe I don't believe he's the cheating type.
But, okay. Well, I'm not even...
Everybody that knows this everybody that knows him has always said he has never done that. He never would this.
The non-cheating types don't put themselves in situations where the speculation could be out there that they are cheaters.
Right.
And staying in a room with an ex-girlfriend for 4 nights is certainly going past the borderline of where speculation is drawn as to your ability to be faithful.
And actually, usually in a 2-year relationship, you meet some of your boyfriend's old high school buddies, college buddies, whatever.
Terry,
regardless,
I'm so flabbergasted by this call.
I love trying
to work the word flabbergasted into every show, Terry, and I can never usually find a way.
He's carved out a pretty nice little situation.
He has. Absolutely.
It's almost so easy for him that it's not as fun.
I mean, he might as well just sleep with her in front of the girlfriend.
Right.
Say, oh, I'm not doing her. Really, I'm not. It's just a figment of your imagination.
Mm-hmm.
It's an illusion, honey.
Man.
Oh, walks out of the bathroom in the hotel room. Ooh, my towel fell off. Whoops.
Oops.
That's how it starts.
I'm going to ask one more time.
I think it started there.
Yeah,
okay. I think in 2 years, come on.
I'm going to ask you one more time because it shocks me to hear the answer you've thrown back at us. You really believe they're going to spend 4 nights in Vegas in the same room?
There's going to be other. There's going
and
to
have
other
no
people in the room.
Mm-hmm. Who else is going to be in the room? Siegfried and Roy.
Another girl and another guy.
Oh my God!
So they're going as couples.
They're going as couples. Yes, they are. They're going as couples, honey.
Are the other two a couple?
No.
Oh, but they're going as couples.
It's ridiculous.
Four people in one room with a Luxor, man.
I know.
It's an orgy, isn't
that
it?
That sounds comfortable, huh?
Yes.
Seriously.
Why can't you? Why can't you go if there's four people and some of them are not a couple?
I wasn't invited.
Why weren't you invited?
And when I asked him, you know, why wasn't he inviting me? Because it's a trip with his old friends.
I don't understand that at all.
I don't get it either.
Don't you think it's reasonable based on that explanation that he gave you for you to break up with him?
I was trying to be understanding and trusting. But instead, I feel like I'm just...
Understanding and trusting is a great quality. There's no doubt about it. But when it crosses the borderline of being ridiculous and absurd, then that just makes you look like an idiot.
Yeah.
He's walking all
and
over
I'm
you,
all
honey.
For women being idiots. I love it. But you're on the phone with me, not him. If he was on the phone with me, I would tell him, I would give him strategies on how to make this work. But you're here. I mean, at minimum, while he's gone, go find his ex-girlfriend's fiancé and screw him.
No, I'm not like that.
Right, because either is he. You're a faithful couple.
Mm-hmm.
Devoted to the day you die.
So if you guys ever get married, are these friends going to not be at the wedding?
That's what I'm wondering, because I've met a couple of the people that he went to school with, but it's just like by running into him at the store.
And does he introduce you as, hey, this is my girlfriend, da da da, or does he say, hey, this is so
and
so?
Yeah, and there's one girl that she came to where I work and asked to see me and talk to me, and he seems fine with that, but he just doesn't want me to know this little group of friends, and that's what I don't get.
Well, you wonder
because
why.
This little group of friends get together and they have little secrets amongst themselves because they all screw around with one another and then they go back to...
What do you do?
I'm a server at a restaurant.
What restaurant?
And I go to school. I'm a single mom, so...
What restaurant?
Claim Jumper.
Big portions, baby.
Oh, chicken fried steak hanging over the plate.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I see people walking out with stuff. No, you got to eat it all while you're there.
That's what Steven
I serve
does.
It. I don't eat it.
You know, maybe her ultimate goal in all this, again, Terry, was just to be qualified, and I might have qualified her.
Uh-huh.
But she said she's a faithful girl. We don't need that.
Okay.
I can send you a picture. I'm cute.
All right, send us a picture. Go ahead. In the meantime, we hope you enjoy those 4 days that you'll have to yourself, where your boyfriend will be in Vegas being a complete gentleman. And faithful and respectful of your relationship. All right?
All right.
Call us back and let us know how your relationship continues to go, okay?
Okay. If I send you a picture, will you, and I call back, will you let me go? Because I know if you see me, you'll let me go.
Wow. Well, I certainly can't rule that out. It's a possibility.
Okay.
All right?
Do you want to, when is the trip?
The trip is at the end of the month.
Okay, because see, I can even send you before and after pictures.
Before and after of what?
Breasts. The
boobs.
The boobs.
Oh, that's right, she's getting boobs.
Mm-hmm. Send a picture of chicken fried steak while you're at it, would you?
Because Hot Shot's hungry right now.
Hot Shot's that big chocolate cake.
Hot Shot has just qualified chicken fried steak to be on the plane to Vegas. Man.
Man. It's a better time, even though only 5-10 years ago I was actively in this dating world, Terry.
Mm-hmm.
It's a better time now than ever before.
And times were good back then.
I can't. I'm trying to think of any girls that I ever had anything remotely serious with that would have let me go to Vegas with an ex-girlfriend.
Okay, and stay in the same room.
Trying to think of one.
Jeez.
That I can't.
Without something flying
at
your head, right?
He tells her straight-faced and everything.
I'd have to perfect the art of lying. That's what we had to do back in the day. You don't have to do that anymore. You don't have to be a good liar anymore.
They got it easy these days.
Unbelievable.
The T-Man.
Be careful, don't fool with that.
Mm-hmm.
Hit me.
It's the get on board and go to Vegas with the cube staff thingy.
That seems pretty senseless, but whatever.
If you prefer the buffet over the pool, then please don't call it.
Right.
A little less conversation, a little more action.
And no doubt about that.
All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me.
You said it.
A little more bite, a little less bark.
Mm-hmm.
A little less fight, a little more spark.
Sure.
Hold your mouth and open up your heart and maybe satisfy me.
Oh, that sounds like a plan. You're out of the air. Hello.
Hi, T-Man. How you doing this morning?
Good, dude. What's up?
Hey, I wanted to ask you a question. What your personal opinion was on this situation here? Me and my buddies, we've been having a conversation about this one.
I have no opinion.
Oh, you don't have an opinion? Well, we'd appreciate if you or any of your staff on your morning show to share their opinion.
Oh, okay. Tell us the scenario. Maybe I'll have an opinion.
My buddy last night, he was over at some chick's house that's engaged and she's had a kid with him. She's been with him for 8 years. And he's trying to tell us this morning that, because me and my other buddy, we've, you know, slept around and stuff like that. We've had married girls here and there that were willing to offer themselves.
Sure. Right.
Of course,
never doubted
up
it.
On their offer.
Yeah. What are you saying? This guy went over to a woman's house who is engaged? She's engaged?
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
She has a wedding date set, to your knowledge, or what's the deal there? Does she have an actual target date as to when she's going to get married?
She don't have, as far as I know now, she don't have any target date. But I know right now her floodgates are open for my friend to go ahead and fill them.
All right, and you're telling him not to go?
No, I'm totally telling him to go for it. Go gung-ho for it. She's willing to offer herself. I take her up.
All right, so then what's the problem? He's going. So what's the deal? Where's the issue?
Well, I don't know. I think he might be scared of the girl or something like that.
Oh, he didn't go? I thought you said he went last night and had sex with her.
Well, see, the whole thing is that he's trying to tell me and my friends that we're hypocrites because we slept around with other married girls before, whatever, and he's trying to tell us that it's not the same thing. And we're telling him that she's been together with the guy for 8 years, and they're basically married, and that he should take her up on the opportunities he's offering.
Dude, I don't understand the issue, man. Did he not go last night? Is that why you're ridiculing him? Or did he go last night and do it?
Well, he's trying to tell us that he just went last night and talked to her the whole time.
Oh, he didn't have sex with her.
We're trying to tell him that something else happened. We know that.
All right, so what's the problem? What are you asking of me?
I want you to tell my friend to eat up his words because he's calling me a hypocrite because he's saying what he's doing right now isn't wrong.
What he's doing right now isn't wrong.
Huh?
What he's doing right now isn't wrong.
But he's going over to a girl's house that's engaged.
So what? That's her problem. That's not his problem. She's opening the door, right? If she'll open the door for me later today, I'll go in.
You used to do it all the time, too.
And if I do, that's my problem in my marriage. Everyone's responsible for their own relationship. This man is not in a relationship. It's not his problem. If she's opening the door for him and he's single and he has nothing to worry about or feel guilty about, he has no responsibility to keep her relationship intact.
All right, then I guess I'm going to have to say sorry, too. It sounds like
there
I'm eating
go.
My words.
Because the burning bush has spoken.
The burning bush has spoken.
Mm-hmm. Man, how many times have I said that over the years, by the way?
Plenty.
Do I need to write a book?
Yes.
To put it all in print?
I guess so.
The T-Man rules?
Yeah.
Man. I couldn't tell what it was. Easy.
I know.
You're on the air. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. Don't talk trash to me, okay?
I just said hello so far.
Boy, that's a lot of trash talking.
Man.
Hello.
What's wrong with you? What can we do for you?
Nothing. I want to go on the trip.
Well, who doesn't, honey?
Yeah.
Who doesn't want to go on the trip?
I know.
Let me clear the lines and take calls from people who don't want to go on the trip, Terry.
Okay.
No. Hello? Don't. He hung up on me.
No, I didn't.
Okay. See, we're listening to the radio, too. Don't hang up, T-Man.
Who's the giggling baboon you have there in the background?
My coworkers.
Mm.
They're not baboons, though.
Right. Where do you work? What do you do?
I work at a radio, or not a radio station, I'm sorry, that's what you do.
No, that's what I do.
Yeah, okay. Yes.
And I'm one of the baboons. People from other radio stations wanting to be on the plane.
Yeah. That doesn't work.
Is this Delilah?
Right. Every other show wants to go on this party plane to Vegas, Stephen. Don't doubt it.
I work at a car dealership.
Mm-hmm. Which mm-hmm. one?
The place where you bought your car from.
My car? Which car?
Yeah.
What place?
Nice one.
Which
nice
one?
Mm,
yeah,
which one?
Barrier Mercedes.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Like you don't have two nice cars or something.
Well, I'm actually needing to buy a car in the near future, so if I say no to this woman...
Ooh.
I don't know.
So she's dangling keys
she'll
in
sell
you
a lemon. Yeah, sugar on the gas tank on the way home.
Well, the good thing is we don't have any lemons on our lot, so...
All right, whatever. Yeah, of course. Nobody does. Anyhow...
The emergency alert system by the King County Sheriff's Office Communications Center. In the event of an emergency, the system will bring you important information. The following tones conclude this test.
Okay, maybe I'll give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
Not asking for it. You're on the air.
Hey.
Yes.
What's up, boss man?
How are you, sir?
Uh-oh.
It's a great way to start your call.
Yep.
I'm trying to be in Sin City with you, spend back to Spearmint Rhino. What can I do to
get
there?
Okay, now let me get this very clear right now.
Yes.
To the men who actually make it on this plane, and there will be a nice, sizable portion of men, Terry.
35%?
It's going to be at least 35% men on this party plane to Vegas.
Sir.
Don't think you're going to be in the Spearmint Rhino with me putting lap dances together as we hang as brothers, all right? I go to strip joints alone, like a normal person.
Yeah, we'll be at the Peppermint Hippo, not the Spearmint Rhino.
So you'd never catch yourself at Spearmint Rhino?
I
didn't say that.
No, I don't like the one in Vegas. I don't like. I like the Spearmint Rhino in L.A. If I'm gonna go to Vegas, I'm going to Sapphires.
Oh.
You what? You following me?
Well, have a great day.
Yeah, thanks for the call.
Yeah. Man, people.
Hey, team man, it's me. Hey.
Let me go.
All right.
Man,
and you're on the air.
Team man, I would like some special treatment.
Who's this? Is this the girl called the other day?
Yeah.
Hey, Gina, what? Come on. This is getting ridiculous.
Oh,
what
come
do you
on.
Want? What do you want?
I
want to You didn't
to
make
Vegas
it the other day. I don't think you're going to make it today. I have to qualify someone. I'm 2 hours late to qualify someone, and I'm not feeling it again, Terry.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm not feeling it.
Well, then have her email.
T-Man, you have my email.
She did email.
Oh,
she
did
sent
email.
Pictures. Oh, I look like Jessica Simpson.
Oh, boy.
I got all your emails, Gina.
Yeah.
Deleted them 2 seconds after I got them.
No, you didn't.
Well, Gina, all I'm telling you is it's getting a little ridiculous. Stop it. Man. You're on the air.
How you doing, T-Man?
This is the guy. This is the guy I've been waiting for.
He sounds awesome.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
didn't quite hear you, but I was just calling to, well, of course, try to qualify.
All right.
One way or another. I went to your ham sandwich release party. That was tight.
All right.
Always a fan of hammy.
Can you sound a little bit more nonchalant, sir? Could you sound a little bit more relaxed, please?
Oh, no. It's my bad. I've been up all night working.
All right.
I get off in like 4 minutes.
But I was hoping like I could put up like my thousand chip poker set, like play someone in
We're
poker,
not looking for we're not looking for bribes, sir, for people to get on this plane.
No, I mean put it up as in, if you win, you get my chip set. Oh, I mean, it's
sir, this
an
is
idea,
this is not you call us, you offer us your crap. We're just looking to qualify someone to go on the trip to Vegas.
And
didn't you hear me play the sounder? Didn't you hear me play the theme song this morning? Ah!
And don't you have a ton of poker chips already?
Get on board and go to Vegas with the Cube.
Terry, I can wallpaper my house with poker chips.
Yeah.
Whatever.
If you prefer the buffet over the pool, then please don't call us.
And the personalized, right?
All this aggravation ain't satisfaction.
Sure.
A little more bite, a little less bark.
Yeah, right.
A little less fight, a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart, and maybe satisfy.
All right, Steven, you take the next call. Maybe you'll have better luck, all right?
Oh, come on.
Okay.
It's Steven Takes a Call.
Wow.
On the T-Man of the Morning Show, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, what's happening?
Hi, this is T-Man Show.
It is. What's going on?
Hi, I was just...
See, it sounds like better luck already.
I couldn't hear what you said. There was somebody else talking. Go ahead.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi.
I am the girl that went to Vegas with that chick's ex-boyfriend.
I am the girl that went to Vegas with that chick's ex-boyfriend.
Yeah, that was just on.
Ah, I see.
Oh.
She hasn't gone yet.
Yeah, she hasn't.
What are you talking about? According to that girl's story, they haven't gone yet.
No. They went. I went to Vegas with her ex-boyfriend.
Again, according to the story she told us, they haven't gone yet.
They haven't gone yet?
Yeah.
No, so wait, I'm the coach that licked the blood.
Right.
The bloody knee.
Whatever you want.
Whatever you need me to be. DeGeneres.
Okay, well,
I've got polyps.
Heard that they had already gone.
No, they haven't already gone. You got to listen more closely when you're about to call in with a lie.
Right. Okay. Yeah, get the story right.
Well, you could have got that one by me.
She's a hot liar, though.
She hung up. She said, she did sound like a hot liar.
She had a skinny laugh.
Good one.
She had a hot sounding voice. She had a skinny laugh. And yet she outsmarted herself. No. By trying to be someone else.
I'm that chick sexier who went to
All
Vegas.
I needed to do was hear her voice, and she was off to a great start.
Yep.
Go ahead, Steven, another one.
Hey, what's going on?
You're on a good streak of one.
Thanks for calling in. What can we do for you? Who's this? You're in.
The best one so far.
It has been the best one so far, he's right. Anyone there? Just a second. Okay, we'll wait.
Yeah, I'm a little busy.
Hey, thanks for calling. What's your name?
My name's Carter.
Carter, what's going on?
Not much. I just need to, I'm trying to, you know, work out this Vegas thing, but I got to tell T-Man something first of all, like, before I even speak.
It's too late, sir.
I gotta give him more credit than 10% on this poor restaurant, man. I gotta tell him the menu is the best I've had in a Seattle restaurant.
Oh, you like my restaurant?
Wow, he really knows how to get in good, doesn't
he?
It's
a good way to do it, Terry.
No, not even on some brownie points. This is real.
Okay.
Because I personally know Chef Howie, and I know his son. And if I were to go to Vegas, that's what I'm bringing. I'm bringing Chef Howie's son with me.
The food's good.
3 days ago, you guys put the brand new honey barbecue sweet bits on there, and I got to tell you.
Sweet bits? Really? Oh, God. Steven's there this afternoon.
I thought that videotape didn't leave my house.
I would eat them every day of the week, and if I could bring them to Vegas with me, I'd do it just because, you know, I like that sport.
No, people
so
have been to the restaurant that I own downtown now, Terry, along with a couple of other guys, have nothing but good things to say, except for the service. There's been a couple of service issues, but that has now been taken care of.
Good deal.
Now you can have your lunch in less than 5 hours.
Nice.
Now you can have your lunch in less than an hour. Now you can have the great food and the great atmosphere that sport delivers to you on a daily basis.
Ah, wonderful.
Always.
Okay.
Hey, but I don't think the thing within 5 hours, they got some pretty good service, and I will tell you, your waiter.
Man, this guy's going off now.
He is.
This guy is doing everything it takes to get on this plane, isn't he?
Hey, well, I already told Eric that, you know, if I get on there, he's going with me. So.
All right. Sounds good.
That's good.
You know, Steven, you want to qualify this guy?
What's that,
T? It's up to Steven, I said, if he wants to qualify you. Do you want to qualify him, Steven? No? Okay, bye.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, but...
But he's bringing Chef Howie's son.
Oh, I say,
come on. But what he already told him.
Terry, he's the chef to the stars.
I understand that.
Have you been to the restaurant yet?
No, I have not. I'm a little busy.
All these people have been to the restaurant and you haven't been?
I have not been.
Steven's been to the restaurant?
Wait. Time out before you start going off.
Steven, did you like the restaurant?
Wait.
I did, yeah.
You little fellas here love to get together for lunch and talk about it and say that, oh, I don't would never stick around.
Terry,
you guys would never stay.
At 10:02, we said, hey, let's go to lunch today.
No,
where's Terry?
Didn't.
Oh, she's already
Gina,
gone.
Gina, you still hanging on?
Yeah.
Can you blow like St. Helens?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, geez, hang on.
Did she hang up?
Yeah.
I'm here.
Oh.
All right, you're not qualified.
Oh.
Can't do it.
Big Vegas debate. Come on, I'm already
sick. What was wrong with this woman? What's sick? Tell me what's wrong with you. Tell me how sick you are, and then we'll figure out whether it's...
I'm sick in the good ways.
Okay, tell us the good ways.
Oh, well, I'll respond to your email later today, and I'll tell you.
I didn't write you an email.
What?
I didn't write you an email.
Oh, okay.
Did I write you an email?
Yes.
No, I did not write you an email.
Well,
someone else is writing you an email and signing it.
Went into the T-Man at themanshow.com and responded to the email, I think. Okay.
You're not qualifying. I'll say that over and over again. And now you're definitely not qualifying because now you're making up stories.
I love your restaurant.
Crazy bitch.
Okay.
Man.
Come on.
Come on what?
Come on. Qualify me.
No. Go away.
No. Come on.
No.
It still is only a chance. It's not like you're saying, okay, you're coming. It's just qualifying me for a chance.
Listen very carefully.
Yeah?
Even if I qualified you, I wouldn't pick you.
Oh, why?
Because you seem like a scary groupie.
No.
Yeah, she's won a lot of things here.
Yeah, you've already won a lot of things.
She's
like
won,
what?
She won a key earlier.
Steven!
Come on, I'm the president of your fan club, remember?
Oh, that's all I need to hear. Okay, thanks, how we go.
Crazy.
There's got to be hot groupies we've never met.
Is she hot?
I think so.
You think she's hot?
Well, you said Jessica Simpson, right?
No, I know who she is. I mean...
Is she hot?
Yeah.
I said Jessica Simpson because she said Jessica Simpson.
Oh.
Have you seen her?
I think I've seen her, but...
Is she hot?
I think she's pretty hot, yeah, if I remember correctly.
Should have flagged me down.
She was at one of the...
Is that why you're writing her back as me? That's exactly why I did that.
The T-Man.
To properly show Dentine Ice in action, but without being too...
Kids in Seattle are among the most vulnerable in the country to developing asthma. A new survey is out tonight.
Really?
Seattle is second only to Dallas for the worst cities for dust mites. The top five cities are on your screen.
That just sounds so gross, huh?
Yes.
Mm, dust mites. I thought the air was so clean here in Seattle. Now I got a picture of dust mites floating everywhere.
Oh, they are.
Oh, there's another one just passed by, Terry.
Seattle is second only to Dallas for the worst cities for dust mites. The top five cities are on your screen.
Oh, yeah,
dust
there they are.
Dust mites can cause asthma symptoms. The Northwest is also bad for mold.
We're number what? I can't believe number five. You're just playing along like they're on the screen there, Steven. That's funny. Anyhow.
Can't all be winners.
There you go. Dust mites.
Yeah, not good.
Mm-hmm.
No clean air here.
So you're a VJ, Terry, attracting all these dust mites?
Oh, yeah. Yep, it's like a magnet.
Okay. It's a dust mite magnet?
Yep. In fact, hold on, let me...
Just nasty. Anyhow.
Guess you gotta move to L.A. for clean air, huh?
Mm-hmm. If we want clean air, we're gonna have to move down to, yes.
If we want rain.
Pasadena, California. Yeah, if we want some rain, we're going to have to move down south.
We might need to.
Man, well, I don't know what to do now at this point, Terry.
We still haven't qualified somebody.
It's 7 o'clock. It's just, let's qualify somebody.
We're good to our word that at 7:14 and 8 o'clock, someone will be qualified.
7:14, how about 7:02?
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah,
7:24 and 8.
All right, well, sometimes... There are some hosts that are a little tardy, only for, with the best intentions, only to make sure that the person qualified is a person that is rightfully going to perhaps get a spot on that plane, Terry.
Yeah, maybe if the others waited long?
Yeah, maybe if the others waited long, I wouldn't be calling up people, telling them they won when they're nothing but just non-party-like types.
How about 9, 3, 6, and 11?
Give me another story, Terry.
Okay.
What do you have
in
there?
The Netherlands, got a strange little sex story.
I think that's where I'm going to have to go to find the people to fill this place.
In the Netherlands?
Yeah.
Hot girls there.
The police there got a call about a kidnapping, and the kidnapping turned out to be a kinky sex game. Apparently, this woman wanted to set it
sounds
up.
A happy ending.
Well, yes. Mm-hmm. However, she got in trouble because it's kind of illegal to do a faux kidnapping to get off sexually.
That's frowned upon by the police and the emergency response people.
Yeah.
Oh, I would think that would be a welcome sight. Well, wouldn't it be great? Wouldn't it be a better world if all 911 calls when the ambulance or the police arrived, if it all turned out to be kinky sex games? Would the world be better, yes or no?
Well, I'm sure it would be better than
okay, then. End of story. You're on the air.
Hello?
Yes.
Hi, I'd like to see if I can qualify for Vegas.
I'd like to see, too.
Well, let's try.
Let's.
What shall we do? Because I'm ready to have some fun.
Continue.
About time to have some fun.
What is fun in your mind?
My mind would be probably not working and taking care of my two children all by myself.
Yeah. Wow!
She's like that bus ride to Hoover Dam sound.
Can I let this woman rightfully go to Vegas for the some odd nights that we're all going and know that her kids are at home without their mama? Can I do that?
Well, I guess you can't, because you're not going to.
Can I, with good conscience, do that?
She probably needs a break, though.
Yeah, Terry's going. She has five kids.
Yeah, I got five.
That's why I can't let Terry go.
Oh.
It's coming down to the point where I'm just going to take the first caller.
Oh.
All right?
Oh, no.
Let me go to the first caller I can find.
And now, representing butt rockers worldwide, carrying sod from Tacoma to Everett and every city in between, president of the blue collar workers, even though he wears a tank top, here's Dump Truck Guy.
The reality is, Dump Truck Guy, twice because of this program, has gotten to go to Vegas and have a good old Vegas time.
That's right, twice.
But that's not what I'm calling.
I believe you. What is the purpose of your call?
Just take this freaking thing to the internet already, would you, please?
Yeah, we're going
to
do that.
These people just suck.
What? There's no doubt about it. I'll be the first to tell you he's right.
We're taking it to the internet?
I'm going to be reading emails. For those out there who are not able to get through on the phone lines, the funny thing is, the phone lines couldn't be more slammed, okay? I mean, we always have all the lines filled, but the way they're filled now, you can just feel the intensity on the phone lines. So as soon as we disconnect one call, it's ringing just like that very second.
Right.
Usually there's like a 10-second delay before that line gets filled up, or a 20-second delay. It's instantaneous.
And you got too many pills. T-Man, I got an 80-inch penis.
Ouch.
I mean, how many times does that work? Come on.
Wow, Dump Truck Guy sounds like he all of a sudden is interested in going.
Yeah, he's been on Bigger City, it sounds like.
Mm-hmm. No.
And Dumpy, you were missed over the past number of weeks. How's life? How is things going for you?
Oh, man, just trying to make a freaking buck and spending more than that. Just gay.
You can't.
It's just gay.
You can't make it as fast as you're spending it, is what you're saying.
Man, the more I make, the more I gotta freaking pay out. I'm just getting tired of it.
What is it? That out of control spending, Joanne, million hairs of yours, or what?
No, I just been having little issues here and there. Anytime I got cash, little issues, something breaks or something freaking goes goody bag, and then just hate life takes all my ducats, man. It's just.
All right, so what happened recently that cost you a lot of money?
Oh, my car's crapping out.
Oh, wow.
Which car?
My Lincoln.
The Navigator?
Yeah.
Whoa, did you just get that?
I already spent $400 on this thing, and it runs worse than it ever did.
This is what happens when you buy a used car.
Well,
you don't know what you're getting. You don't know who drove it.
A new one.
Well, get a lesser car, but get a new one.
I'm not driving a Hyundai. Sorry.
Oh, wow.
You're driving nothing now, it sounds like.
Oh, jeez.
Take your pick.
No, so hopefully the freaking black cloud's going to fly away.
Wow.
That'll be good to go.
Yes. Well, it's funny, though. The black cloud is there whenever you feel like you've got a lot of money in your
It's just a couple extra dollars.
Yeah, whenever you have a few extra dollars, there's always something that comes up.
Something comes up.
Always. And it always costs twice as much as you got.
Yeah, I know. That's
like that
ridiculous
yearly payment you have to make on the tanning bed?
No, it's already paid, man.
Oh, I forgot.
That son of a bitch out.
You paid in full, and now he's renting it out for people in the neighborhood
you
who want
should
a deep, dark, dumpy tan.
It's up, man.
What do you...
Actually, I've been bailed out on that thing, man. I just went a couple nights ago for a half hour and burnt the crap out of me.
What do you charge per pop for a neighbor to spend some time in your tanning bed?
Shoot, I hadn't even thought about it, but bring it on. It's cheaper than anywhere else, guaranteed.
Get a punch card going.
Bring over some Bud Lights and you're in.
Damn right, man.
And how's Bubba and the family?
Oh, he's doing good. Bubba's freaking A-ing, man. A-ing in school. Unbelievable.
Wow, very good.
No teacher conference needed. I was like, huh?
That means.
It was my kid's name, and it was. So
all it means is that Bubba's now old enough to have sex with his female teachers, and he's getting aged.
Wow.
All right. Very good, Dubby.
Hi, brother. You have a good day. Congratulations on the new Rugrats.
Yeah.
That's
why I'm so tired, Terry.
Oh, hey,
That's why I have no tolerance. I woke up at 1 o'clock yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't even fall back to sleep after taking a sleeping pill. Just lying there. Kick in, sleeping pill, kick in! I'm thinking, okay, now it's kicking, and now I feel something. Okay, now I'm going to fall asleep. No! So I'm all doped up,
mm-hmm,
underslept here at work.
Ah, oh, welcome to my world.
I honestly don't even know if it was a sleeping pill. It might have been something else.
That's the thing that kills me. You don't even know.
It was from an unlabeled bottle. I can't remember what it was. I thought it was a sleeping pill.
That's great.
Anyhow.
Did your mom
maybe
teach
it was a
you
keep
not
you up one.
To do that?
Unless I know, Steve.
It could have been a keep you up pill. What do you call those?
Keep you up pill?
Like a non-sleeping pill?
Non-drowsy formula.
All right, you get back to us, huh, Steven?
The reverse of that. What do you call that?
A no-dose pill?
Yeah, something
okay.
Like that.
Glad I could get the assist there.
Thank you, John Stockton.
I'll tell you what.
Yes?
www.thetmanshow.com for people who cannot get through to this program right now, who have very much to say about how much in need we are for them and they are for us as far as this trip to Vegas is concerned, Terry. It's come to that, no doubt about it.
Wow.
I am on concern mode as far as who we have filling up this plane.
Okay.
Maybe it won't be my visual of 200 hookers sitting there in the sky with us going down to Vegas.
Probably not.
But if I can get it to a point where it's still fun,
mm-hmm,
wouldn't that be something you would want to?
Absolutely.
But if you can do 200 hookers, we'll take that as well.
So really what you're saying is that the callers just haven't really stepped up to the plate. And
you would disagree?
Well, I mean, some of them sound all right, but...
All right, then you take the next call. Go ahead.
Hey, welcome to the T-Man Show.
Oh, jeez.
Yes.
What's going on?
This is your party girl.
Can't really tell, though.
That's what we're getting.
Yeah.
This is your party girl.
Oh, okay.
I am nonstop excitement. No one can hold a candle to my ability to party. Is that what it is? Is that what the party girl sounds like these days?
So they have to come on woohooing and arebaing and all that kind
of
stuff?
Well, I mean, the party girl, first of all, shouldn't sound like she's 52.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
true.
All right.
She did sound that way. She's the Tupperware party girl.
I don't know what they should sound like, but that I just know when I don't hear it.
You're just not feeling it at all.
Yes. This is your party girl.
Maybe this is what's keeping you up.
Yeah. Hey, welcome to the T-Man Show.
Hello.
Hi. How you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. What's going on?
I know two people that you should definitely let on this plane. It's me and my mom.
Your mom?
Me and my mom. I just turned 21. She's 41.
I don't mind this, Terry. I don't mind this. Keep it going.
Okay. And so do you guys go out often together?
We go out all the time together. We've won Mardi Gras contests together.
Mardi Gras, right?
We are definitely the party animals.
Oh, wow. What do you guys do together that's, you know?
You ever made out with the same guy?
No, not yet.
Why not?
Don't give me not yet.
If you haven't done it, you're not going to do it. Why not? Why isn't that your style?
We just don't go that way, I guess.
Is your mom there?
She's not here. I was actually just on the other line with her, though.
When was the last time she had sex?
Probably this morning.
With who?
With her husband.
Well, she's married.
Oh, geez.
She's married to your dad?
She's married, but she, you know, not in Vegas.
Is she married to your dad?
She's not.
She's not. Okay, good. Because if she was married to her dad, then she wouldn't let her mom get freaky in Vegas. But
right.
If she's not married to her
dad.
That's right. Right. She could care less. Yeah, she's not the old stepdaddy.
Especially if she's married to a guy that she doesn't really like.
Which it sounds like she doesn't.
Is your mom married to a guy that you're not really into?
I'm into him all right.
Has he ever hit on you?
No.
Why'd you say It's either a no or a yes. It's not an no. There was a kind of, there was a time you thought he might have been hitting on you, huh?
Right.
So that's why you're not into
him. What did he do that you thought he might have been hitting on you? And have you told your mom about this?
Oh, I think my mom knows.
What did he do?
No, he didn't really do anything.
What did he do?
Let us be the judge of this.
He put his arm around you?
Yes.
Pinched your ass? What did he do?
Grabbed my ass.
Twisted your left nipple?
See,
both
now
of them.
You
know. Both of them.
What did he do? Tell me what he did.
Oh, he didn't do anything.
He did what?
He didn't do anything.
We just said a minute ago he might have done. Yeah, I'm about to give her the heave-ho, Terry.
Man.
She
was real close.
I totally
she was very
liked,
close.
I kind of liked the mother-daughter party
right,
combo.
Right, right.
You guys need to see us.
Oh.
Definitely need to see us.
You got internet access there?
My mom does at work, actually.
When was the last time you had sex? When was the last time somebody slammed you, honey?
It's been a while. That's why I need Vegas.
How long's a while?
been some months.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's
what Vegas is there.
If you're so hot, how come it's not happening for you?
I don't know. Maybe I'm too hot.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
I had that problem all the time.
Right.
Had it all through college, high school, everything.
Yes.
Yeah. Too hot. Things aren't working out for me.
So my wife tells me these days I'm too hot to have sex with.
Right.
Why? When was the last time you got slammed up against a wall?
When was? I don't know, maybe 3 months ago.
By an ex-boyfriend or just a friend with benefits?
By an ex-boyfriend.
Whatever. You're saying everything now that is the most convenient thing to say.
Yeah. No,
you started off a house of fire, honey.
Yeah, she did.
Now you're holding the cane, ready to put it around her neck and pull her off stage. Huh?
That's the problem. We talk to people too much.
What do you want, Steven?
I want honest answers.
Oh, well, I know you do.
Then don't call me Steven. Is that too much to ask?
No, it's not. It's not.
What else do you have to say?
You're
hanging. You're hanging by a thread right now.
You need to let us on there.
Yeah, you've said that already. We need to let you on. Why?
Because you will not meet a mother-daughter anywhere that can party as much and party as well as we can. Trust me.
What's your definition of partying well?
Partying crazy. You want us to show some boobs? We will. We're crazy.
Well, I get the feeling I'm not going to want it when I'm down there.
Well...
Crazy!
Yeah, you guys crazy. Sound like you.
That's so crazy, Terry!
Watch out for those two.
It's true.
When was the last time you and your mom went out?
Last weekend.
Where'd you go?
We just went. We went to somewhere around Puyallup. I live in Puyallup.
Oh Lord.
We didn't.
She doesn't even know where she would.
You don't know the name of the club in Puyallup?
Because she's lying.
Oh.
We're not
so
lying.
Mom is, and daughter
where'd you
really
go? There's only
part.
One club in Puyallup.
Yeah, the Ferris wheel.
No, they went out to the Outback and then went to a movie and then went home.
Not quite.
You went to the Ram and tore it up.
Why don't you just have us up there? We can show you exactly
how
we would be.
That's fine. I'll tell you what. Why don't you two come down tomorrow morning?
Okay.
All right?
Okay, we will
Very
do that.
Good. Well, hang on. We'll give you directions. And if you blow like St. Helens, then we'll all be good. That's a great way to end it.
Okay.
Why don't you just... That was a great line, she said. Why don't you just have us down, and you'll figure it all out.
There you go.
I'll take one look at them and know if they're plain material, Terry.
Okay.
They're going to stick a toe in the door, and I'll tell you if they're plain material.
So,
why do people want to go on this plane if they know they're not plain material, Terry?
Maybe they want to become plain material somehow.
You're not going
to
become plain material overnight. You're not going to become party plain material in a couple of weeks.
You got to start somewhere.
This isn't boot camp, all right? This is for savvy, seasoned veterans only.
This is a party plane. That word should not be lost in the shuffle here. There's going to be a big extravaganza type evening event where all the listeners get together with the staff.
Mm-hmm.
And we do stuff.
Oh.
And at some point we'll see Eric Powers dance.
Oh, boy.
Can't wait for that.
And then Harris joins in.
Oh, man.
This strip definitely has a lot of downsides, doesn't it?
I didn't really thought about it.
Yes.
Well, now.
Please don't mention him ever again.
Sorry.
Thank you.
The T-Man. The biggest kid.
Warning tonight for kids who are crazy about energy drinks.
Oh,
doctors at the University of Michigan say they can have too much caffeine and other ingredients, and that can be dangerous for kids.
So he's recommending go back to gin and tonic. Anyhow.
Wow. really?
What else? One quick story, Terry. What do you have? And then I got to qualify like the first listener I can find, and that's it. That's it. End of story. Makes it a lot easier. A lot less stress involved, because I'm at the point now where I'm ready to just have, as a member of this party, playing this guy. I'd rather have him, Terry.
Come on.
What's a party without me on that board, that plane? Because I'll take that ass down and I'll park my cockpit right where it belongs.
Oh, my God.
At least there'd be some excitement,
goodness
Terry.
Goodness
I'm like Michael Jackson. When I get partying, I find tricycles in my driveway.
Okay.
You might be on the Jen Dalton blacklist, by the way.
Yeah, I think so.
There are some listeners, actually, out there that would probably enjoy John being a part of this party play. They've never had the John experience up close and personal.
Okay.
And until you've had the John experience up close and personal, you don't realize it's the last thing you want in the world.
Right.
Most listeners have never met John. They think they can handle him, and he's not really like this off the air. They think that's just his way of being when he's on the air, not realizing that when you're in his presence off the air, that's him.
Yeah.
Nonstop. 24 hours a day, in your face, following you around wherever you go.
Yes.
For the rest of your life.
Watch out.
They don't know that at this time, Terry. And I'm telling you, there are a lot of listeners out there that say, hey, if I get a seat on that plane, I hope John's there too. He sounds wacky.
He is wacky.
What's better than bringing a good old drink to the old T-Man party plane? Because when I get aboard that cockpit, baby, you better sit back and relax and enjoy the ride.
Okay, whatever, dude.
So we're flying differently, right?
Okay. A new study by Ohio State University's College of Medicine finds that when someone who is in a conflict-ridden marriage gets injured, they don't heal as quickly as somebody who's in a happy marriage.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, a happy marriage, you heal quicker.
Yes. Yep.
No wonder I've had this paper cut that's not life-threatening, Terry.
Well, see, there you go.
Ah.
So it is very important that, you know.
Wondrous.
If you have good health in your marriage.
If you're happy in your marriage, you heal quick.
That's right.
You're unhappy in your marriage, even the slightest of wounds.
Yes.
Become major penetrations of your being.
Right. You don't produce repair proteins.
Steven, how are your cuts healing these days?
Everything seems to be fine.
Steven hasn't had a cut in his life. You know why he hasn't had a cut in his life? Because he's never taken a running step. He's never jumped. He's never made an athletic maneuver.
I thought he had shin splints at one time.
That was because of his thyroid condition.
Oh. What?
Well, I had a condition, yeah.
He had shin splints, not because he was a big runner or something. No. He had a thyroid condition, right or wrong.
I actually was a runner at the time. But
you were not a runner.
I actually was. But the shin splints, they weren't really shin splints. That's just what they felt
You've
like.
Never even been in a slow jog a day in your life.
Okay.
I'm wrong?
I think you're wrong, yeah.
He's a big tennis star, I thought. You played tennis when you were younger.
You still do, don't you, sometimes?
Well, yeah, you don't need to really get into a big, heavy little jog on that.
Him and Pasty get on the court.
That's right.
Oh, Pasty cigarette dangling out of his mouth. I don't think you need to run after any balls, Terry.
All right, dude, it's your turn, girl.
Paw Patrol is shagging the balls for us.
First caller right now. That's what it's come down to, Terry.
Oh,
ladies
boy.
And gentlemen, here we go. Here we go. Because I've tried all morning to find the right-sounding person, and I failed again. I'm going to read the emails tomorrow morning, Terry.
Okay.
Go to thetmanshow.com and send your emails, and I'll pick the best email tomorrow. That's what it's going to take. But right now, what's the number here? 1-866-663-T-MAN. The first caller is going to qualify. Now, should I clear these lines or keep them tied up? What should I just punch up a line?
You're going to have to clear them
all.
Clear them all.
Clear them all?
Yes, yes.
Clear them all 100 times through.
Okay. Let me just clear like a good 10 of them. Sorry, dude. Gotta let you go, or ma'am. Sorry, I gotta let you go. Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
No, please don't. I've been on hold for so long.
Really?
Yeah, I was on hold for like a half hour.
And what'd you want?
I got hung up on, and then I called back, and I finally got through again. Please don't.
What'd you want to say?
Huh?
You got hung up on after you were on the air?
No, after I was on hold for like a half hour.
You never made it? You never made it on the air?
No.
What'd you want to say?
I want to say that I want to go on the plane so bad.
All right, you qualified. Hang on.
Wow!
Good job.
Woohoo! Riba, chichi.
Gotta keep it simple, Terry.
Should have been simple, like at 7 o'clock.
If I ask her why she wants to go on the plane, it's just going to be a nightmare.
Ever since, what are you wearing?
All right, you asked for it.
Ever since I lost
my leg. Yeah, why do you want to go on the plane?
Why do I want to go on the plane? I've never been to Vegas. I'm 25. I've been with my boyfriend for like 6 years, but I'm so done.
You're so done with him?
I'm done.
And you want to make a statement in Vegas and just screw about 8 or 9 people, don't you?
Yeah. And I want to take my best friend with me and leave my boyfriend home with our son. I need to go have some fun.
Oh, see, I told you.
That's the problem.
Talking to him.
Uh-huh. It's the talking to him part that ruins everything.
It's pretty standard on most dates, I think, really.
Are you hot? So it's just a microcosm of all the social world?
Correct.
I got it. Are you hot or not?
I'm all right. I used to be better before I had my son, but I'm still good looking.
All right, first caller, 1-866.
Elvis tried to tell you, a little less conversation, a little more action. Been saying it all morning.
What's your name?
Krista.
How old are you?
25.
Right. Why are you done with your boyfriend, who you have a kid with?
It's just getting old, and it's been 6 years, and he just doesn't do anything.
How many men have you had sex with in the past 6 years?
Two.
Him and who else?
Another guy from when we were separated for a couple months.
The real baby's daddy.
Sometimes that's what people say, but no.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, you can try to qualify tomorrow, okay?
Why not today?
Ah, I'm out of time.
No, you still need to qualify somebody today, right?
Well, yeah, but I'm going to take the first caller. You can try to call back real quick.
I did call back already. This is my second time.
All right.
You did say you were clearing the lines.
Yeah, I got to clear the lines.
Did. Yeah. You did.
All right.
You already cleared me off once.
All right. No. Here, watch. Here's what it sounds like.
No, you were going to clear her off, and you said hi to her.
Yes.
Yeah, that was wrong.
You did do that.
All right, let's take the first call, all right?
It's me again.
Highly unlikely. You're on the air.
Hello?
No matter what you say, no matter what you do, you're qualified for the trip to Vegas.
Really?
Yeah, let's be careful.
Who's this?
Stacy.
Tell us about yourself.
Well there, T-Man. I'm 5'6", red hair.
We got lucky.
Busty.
Busty?
What's busty?
36.
Busty is 1967, Derek.
I mean, I'm busty.
Yeah.
Yeah, Steven's busty. We have busty already secured. Yeah?
I got a nice little butt on me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What's your social status? You involved with anyone or what?
I'm currently single.
Really?
I'm dating, but, you know, nothing serious.
And who are you going to bring with you if you win the seat on the plane?
I'm not sure.
Nothing.
I was more concerned about myself.
Well, the dude you're dating, is he going to come with you or no?
No. It's not serious like that.
Uh-huh.
It's
not serious. You a big woman?
No, not at all.
Roomy?
What, roomy?
Yes.
What does roomy mean?
Through the thighs and hips or what?
I'm not big. I'm not like a twig. I'm curvy, athletic.
Uh-huh.
Curvy, give us a laugh.
Athletic. Lane Bryan curvy, huh?
Yeah, those are two words you want to stay away from on the internet, by the way, when you're chatting with people. Curvy and athletic from a woman. Never good.
She said she's 5'6", though.
What?
So, you said you were 5'6", right?
Yeah.
So she can
and what do you weigh, like 170?
No, like 150.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right, well, I said you qualified.
Cool.
Yeah. You wear makeup or no?
A little bit. I don't overdo it.
Yeah.
Yeah, not
start overdoing it. If you're going to go to Vegas with us, all right?
Cool.
All right, how old baby. Are you?
23.
23?
Yeah.
How many kids?
Zero.
Whoa.
You like women at all or no?
No, I've never gone down that road.
Oh, jeez.
I fantasize, but never.
So you find women hot?
They're attractive to me, yes.
How many men would you say you've had sex with in your life?
It's over 30.
Over 30?
Yeah. Oh.
Who was the best
college,
one?
College was good to me.
Where'd you go to college?
UW.
Who was the best one? What was his name? Jeremy Stevens?
Whoa!
I'm just asking.
No, I never did that one.
All right.
Not that one, but...
What was the guy's name who was the best one out of the 30?
The best one?
Yeah.
Drew.
Drew what?
I don't think I should say his last name.
All right, hang on.
Huh?
You've qualified.
All right, cool.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yay, clap, 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 clap.
What's your name?
Stacy.
Stacy.
Hey, Stacy.
What did Drew do? It was so good.
He drew wood.
He just, he knew what he was doing. He got right down to it, to the point. Rough, nice, it was good.
It was rough?
Nice.
A little bit, you know, to a degree.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta have a nice mix.
Okay.
A new mix.
Better mix. Better mix. Hang on, baby.
All right.
Yeah, you're right. She's wearing overalls. I didn't want to ask what she's wearing to her.
Oh, she's a hot little redhead.
Is that right?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Keep the dream alive.
All right. She's qualified. She's Stacy, right?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
The T-Man.